Wow. Chicago's kind of like the National Hockey League's defibrillator. If you weren't ready, it's got your heart going now. 26-year-old Finn Tuukka Rask spent two seasons in the American Hockey League and three as a backup. In his career, he's played all of 30 minutes against the Blackhawks, a relief appearance in a loss 3 years ago. And 28-year-old Corey Crawford from Châteauguay, Quebec, spent five seasons in the American League and was the third goaltender in the Cup run of 2010. He hasn't beaten Boston in two career starts. He lost in a shootout a year and a half ago in the last one. Referees honored to work the Stanley Cup Final, Chris Rooney and Brad Watson. They'll be joined later in this series by Dan O'Halloran and Wes McCauley. Chicago Blackhawks, founded in 1926, 2 years after the Boston Bruins, meeting for the first time in the Stanley Cup Final. Here we go, Canada. It's Boston and Chicago, game one. Jonathan Toews, Patrick Sharp, Marian Hossa, loaded up line for the Blackhawks. Start against David Krejci, Nathan Horton, Milan Lucic, the highest scoring line in the playoffs with 51 points. Brent Seabrook and Duncan Keith back on defense. The puck hit Duncan Keith in the head. He didn't know where it was. Hossa at center. Seabrook jumps up on the play as the puck is dumped in. Jonathan Toews hit hard by Dennis Seidenberg. Get used to that. Zdeno Chara is also on the ice against this Jonathan Toews line. Bruins trying to get organized as Marian Hossa forechecks. In comes Sharp with a hit and a good forecheck for Chicago here. They just about got the puck back. Now a little pass into the middle of the ice and David Krejci starts up. He's got Horton with him. The drop pass. Seidenberg with a shot. Crawford fought it off and the rebound was cleared by Duncan Keith to the blue line. Andrew Ferentz with a shot off a skate and Crawford had to make a sharp save because Duncan Keith had the puck deflect off him right to the goaltender.
Well, it's game on in Stanley Cup Finals, and as Claude Julien always does, you look for matchups. Boychuk started with Chara, and that's he got off the ice quickly. Seidenberg joins in the rush, gets one defensive play and a hard hit on Toews, and then this one, a tough one for Crawford. And the rebound almost went in on Duncan Keith. Look at Keith try to get out of the way. So Crawford tested early on. Good physical start to this game as well.
All of the faceoffs will obviously be important, but it seems as though through the first three rounds of the playoffs, Boston has quite an edge. And Patrice Bergeron has been the best in the playoffs, and he's on the ice right now with his usual line mates, Brad Marchand and Jaromir Jagr. Out against Ryan Bickell. Michael Hanzus and Patrick Kane. Very good second line as Joel Quenneville mixes and matches his top six. Down between the benches as usual for the Stanley Cup Final, Glenn Healy.
Thanks, guys. You know, right away, Chicago Blackhawks have made an adjustment the Pittsburgh Penguins did not make, and that is take the boards away. Boston loved to go around the boards. This is the first shift of the game. Take them away. Sharp does it there. Seabrook does it, and that leads to puck possession.
And Bergeron, as usual, won a faceoff in his own zone. He'll take most of the defensive zone faceoff. That one against Hanzus. Bruins trying to get out of their own zone again. And they get up the boards and outside the blue line, but Hanzus was there to meet them. Andrew Ferentz and Johnny Boychuk. Excellent second pair on defense. In for the puck, Marchand. Bergeron with a hard pass for Jagr, who's yet to score in the playoffs. The pass didn't get through. Patrick Kane, with four goals in the last two games, dumped the puck in. Both teams make changes on the fly. There's diminutive Tory Krug, got to the blue line, turned the puck over. Andrew Shaw, centering pass, and the play was broken up by Adam McQuaid, and he just above cleared the puck over the glass. It hit the top of the glass and stayed in. McQuaid to Krug, under pressure. The Blackhawks, using their speed, have their forecheck going. Shaw with a shot. That's deflected to the corner. Centering pass by Dave Bolin. That didn't quite get to Brandon Saad. An excellent third line shift here for the Chicago Blackhawks. A big hit by Shaw. Brandon Saad comes in. Bolin waiting in front of the net. Back for the puck is third line center Rich Peverly. He got buried, but he got to center. Kaspers Dagamans with Tyler Seguin. And the puck is dumped in, and there was quite a pileup. Gridlock in front of the Boston bench. And Bolin was in the middle of it. He gets at it in a hurry, doesn't he? Back for the puck is Andrew Ferentz. Up the board, Seabrook bobbled the puck, and right on him was Dan Paille. Fourth line shift here for Boston. Paille looking for Kelly or Thornton in front of the net. There's Sean Thornton up, the best fourth line in the league. Made a pass and got nailed by Brent Seabrook. In comes Johnny Boychuk. got by Brandon Bowling and held the puck in. Ferentz pinches on the other side. He gets hit, but he kept the puck in. And another chance from the point. Puck is just held in the corner. Great start here between Boston and Chicago. As you might expect, two excellent teams, two healthy teams in the Stanley Cup Final. There's Michael Frolik, stops and shoots. Bowling in his first Stanley Cup Final game. Hasn't played since the third game of round one, and he gets in because he's a tough physical specimen. Another big hit, that one by Marcus Kruger on Dan Pyatt. In comes Marian Hossa with a shot, and Tuukka Rask calmly catches the puck and stops playing.
We can credit Joel Quenneville putting all his agitators on one line, and that really made a difference as this line for the Chicago Blackhawks gets a great chance in Shaw, but a little too fancy. Early on, maybe a little nervous, didn't take the opportunity to get a shot on net.
3.5 minutes into this game, 10 hits already for the Chicago Blackhawks. Why is it every team the Boston Bruins play, they try to play like the Boston Bruins?
Because they don't want to be pushed around, so they want to show right away that they can play the physical game too.
That worked for Pittsburgh.
Not. David Krejci on the ice again, playing head-to-head with Jonathan Taves. Here's Nathan Horton, gets himself open. Can he get a shot? No, puck drifted on him. And he got to the boards and he got bumped in there by Johnny Oduya. Nicholas Hjalmarsson lifts the puck in the air to center. Hossa was going the wrong way. Krejci comes back. Here's big Milan Lucic. To Horton, his shot is deflected by Oduya, who got up on him in a hurry and deflected the puck up and over the glass.
Let's just finish the deal here and take a look at some more nastiness. They don't play each other very often, but they don't like each other. That's because the prize is so big. It's the Stanley Cup. Seabrook, Thornton, two big bodies. Probably not going to get an advantage like that again against Thornton. And this big hit, Ferentz, Frolik. This is going to be a wild couple of weeks here, judging by the start.
Here's Jaromir Jagr protecting the puck on the boards up against Nick Leddy. And the Blackhawks get the puck and get out. A missed pass goes the distance. Ferentz is back, and there's an icing call against the Chicago Blackhawks. 4.5 minutes in.
So much talk about Jaromir Jagr and his experience. 21 years between Stanley Cup finals. But watch the effort by Duncan Keith. You know you're not going to win the physical battle, so he outquicks him, stays away from him, doesn't allow him to engage and spin off him. And you saw what an active stick Keith had to get that puck away.
Bergeron to face off. Jagr along the boards against Duncan Keith again. Bergeron got slammed into the boards and the play goes to Brent Seabrook. It breaks out. Marcus Kruger in the middle of the ice. Puck's dumped in by Brian Bickle. He's got 8 goals in these playoffs. He scored in 8 different games. Kane in deep. Hanzus is there, so is Bickle. Bruins get the puck and out they come. But the puck got away from Brad Marchand. Keith and Seabrook play a little catch. As the game breathes for a moment and Kane dumps the puck in. Dogovins is back, Boland is right on him. Nice move by Kasper Dogovins. And he just about got himself in a little trouble. Blackhawks, Boland dumps the puck back in. Andrew Ferentz playing some of the best hockey of his career. Veteran defenseman, the Tyler Seguin, has only scored once in the playoffs. Back in come the Blackhawks. Here's Shaw. Sod stopped by Tuukka Rask. 2-on-1 down low, and Rask calmly made another big save. Dogovins late in his shift, dumps the puck in. Tyler Seguin in on the forecheck. Rich Peverly is there as well for Boston. The battle in the corner is won by Chicago. Out comes Pittsburgh native Brandon Sod. Played on the top line most of the season with Jonathan Taves. And he fired another shot that is stopped by Tuukka Rask. And this is predictable. Andrew Shaw going to the front of the net. And he's cleared out in a hurry by the Bruins. They're just starting to get to know Andrew Shaw. They'll know him real well by the time this series is over.
This line has been very effective. And the one thing the Bruins can't do is turn the puck over. You can see Seguin got double teamed there. Turnover. Peverly can't make a play. And then Sod in all alone. And cool customer was Tuukka Rask. Didn't bite, didn't go down. And then Shaw, you know where he's going to go. He's going to be in the front of the net, engage on Chara. And there's a little bit of message sending by the Bruins captain to start off this game.
He's like Dave Boland's twin brother. And appropriately played for the Quinte Red Devils.
Boston has one of them too in Brad Marchand. So both sides are well stocked.
Bowling with a centering pass cleared away by McQuaid off the Boston defense. And the Bruins dump the puck out through the neutral zone. Red Seabrook is back with Duncan Keith. Keith, a great passer and skater, looks up ice. Right onto the tape of Marcus Kruger. A backhander is cleared aside by Tuukka Rask. McQuaid took a hit to make the play to Krug. Dan Pae to center. He'll dump the puck in, and after it goes Chris Kelly and Sean Thornton. Krug from the blue line. Knocked down by Keith. He'll try and take off in a hurry. Quickly up to center. Marian Hossa in on Krug as the Blackhawks change on the fly, trying to get that third pair of defensemen trapped on the ice. Rask saw that, and he stopped the play. Hockey Night in Canada and the Stanley Cup Final on CBC.
It's a vintage photograph featuring Milan Lucic and Jaromir Jagr in our Subway restaurant's bio. Not that Jagr needs it, but everywhere he looks, there are reminders of how old he is. This picture, for example, 10-year-old Milan Lucic on the left with his brothers Jovan and Nikola posing with Jagr in 1998. This was before or after a Penguins game in Vancouver. Lucic tweeted the picture himself on the day the Bruins acquired Jagr, asked him if he had trouble finding it. He said, "Are you kidding me? It's been hanging on my bedroom wall at my parents' home for 15 years. Jim?
Quite a look that Jagr's got going for the Stanley Cup Final with his dyed mutton chops. If Charles Dickens had a hockey player in one of his novels,
that would be him,
just like him.
You get a real sense with such a long time between when these two teams have played. Early on, though, the rivalries are starting right off the bat, aren't they? A lot of good individual battles, one-on-one.
A little more controlled right now. Nick Chalmerson moves up and shoots the puck in wide of the net. Chara is there to Lucic. Oh, he just about sprung David Krejci. Couldn't do it. Cut off by Patrick Sharp. Was out with Hossa and Taves again. Hossa hit hard behind the net. Patrick Sharp trying to get the puck. Krejci back in support of his defense. And again, Blackhawks cut off the boards. Hossa driving to the front of the net. Lost the puck as he bumped the goaltender. And David Krejci starts out. To center, dumps the puck in and changes.
You get a good idea why Claude Julien wants the big bodies against Hossa. He's so difficult to contain one-on-one down low.
One of the strongest players in the league. Here's one of the shiftiest. Patrick Kane to the blue line. Grant Seabrook, slap shot, blocked. Loose puck in front, shot just wide. And a great opportunity for Chicago off a blocked shot. Hansus digging for the puck in the corner. Bickle just about got another one. Keith with a shot, another block just in front of the net. This time, Andrew Ferentz tries to get out of his own zone, and he does to center. Might be a two-on-one. They couldn't quite take advantage. Seabrook is back. Duncan Keith to Seabrook. They delayed enough for a change up front. Now a long shoot in. Rask knocks the puck down. Ferentz is back. And the change is now complete for Chicago. They send out Andrew Shaw, Brandon Saad, Dave Bolin. That's been a really good line early in the game. They've had some great chances. Adam McQuaid dumps the puck in. Roosevelt and Letty, the third defensive pair for Chicago, back. Beverly, Dogovin, Sagan for Boston. A wraparound and a backhand by Beverly. Nothing doing. Both of these teams need some offense out of their third line that they haven't had in the playoffs so far. Might be a difference maker. Puck's knocked down by Tori Krug. Now he feeds the puck in front of the net. And they were unable to tip it. Sagan was right there. Goes the ball cut off. Tyler Sagan, nobody in front to play the puck to. He looked up, but there was nobody there because they'd started a change. The third member of that line had gone off.
I think if he had been a little more aggressive, he might have been able to walk himself. He was looking for the pass immediately.
Looking for Beverly, and he's gone. Kelly had just come on. Here's Nick Letty, another fleet-footed defenseman. A tip in, Bolick, St. Louis, Missouri. In after the puck, Marcus Kruger's there, so is Michael Frolik, number 67. Boston's fourth line is Sean Thornton. Hard around on the other side. This line is missing Gregory Campbell. Kelly fills in there, and a long pass on the left wing with the distance. It's an icing call against Boston.
Well, as predicted, the matchup game continues on, and here's just how you got to play the big body. In on Chara, then he absorbs that hit by Seidenberg, and he just bounces right off him. But what he does so well is he protects the puck and he adds with speed. And he is quite a handful, and that's why Claude Julien wants Chara against him.
Now Boston couldn't change. Fourth line's on the ice, and Chicago comes right back with Jonathan Taves' line. And Duncan Keith has the puck, and Kane's out there as well. is played by Adam McQuaid in front of the net to knock the puck away.
He's right back to Bickle and Kane with Jonathan Toews. So Coach Quenneville making his changes as expected as well.
Well, through these playoffs, those top six have been pretty much interchangeable. After through the regular season, he didn't change them very much at all. Didn't have to. He barely lost. Toews. Kane following. Bruins get the puck. They've made their change. The Krejci line is on. Leading scorer in the playoffs, David Krejci to Milan Lucic. He was looking for Horton. Krejci shoots. Crawford has no holes in him. Makes the save and hangs on. Shots are 5-4 in favor of the Blackhawks. Nicely underway in Chicago at the Stanley Cup Final. Former captains of the Windsor Spitfires, both defensemen, now coaches, hate giveaways, Glenn.
And that's what you can't do if you're the Boston Bruins. You've got to manage the puck. And if you don't manage the puck, you let these guys in red go on offense, and you know they're going on offense. So the key for me would be, for Boston's sake, do not get fished in with giving the puck away. This is the way you fish. You get a glove like Krejci does. Don't give it to the other team to go fishing with.
Michael Heinzer's won the faceoff in his own zone. Chara pinching down the boards, held the puck in. Milan Lucic was poke-checked before he could make a pass. Marcus Kruger, ouch, run into by Lucic. Hossa on his off wing. Bruins get the puck back. Krejci, wing wide. Horton with his shot, that's blocked by Nick Chalmerson. And out comes Marian Hossa with Sharp. And now he's with Hans Dusa. The trainer is Oduya. His shot stopped by Rask, and he holds on. And already, Joel Quenneville continues to adjust his first two lines.
Well, Hossa, nice little delay as he knows he's not going to beat Chara one-on-one very often, but instead stops up, hits the trailing Oduya, and through a crowd, a great positional save by Tuukka Rask, trying to battle through that screen in front, gets out to the top, looks underneath, and as he's done all playoffs long, controlled the rebound exceptionally well.
Wasn't very happy with Sharp there, though. Sharp poking at a puck that wasn't loose.
Chicago got the draw. The shot by Seabrook was blocked. Kane got the puck back in front. Sharp shot. And Rask kept that out. Chara. Another turnover in the neutral zone. The Blackhawks have really stepped up and cut those passes off. Chara again. This time he's up against Kane. This time Dennis Seidenberg carries the puck out. Long shot in wide of the net. Jagr first in on it. Back of the net. For Brad Marchand. Made a nice play to Bergeron, who bobbled the puck and couldn't get the shot. Chara. Seabrook stepped in, and Duncan Keith plays the puck around Marchand. Hanzus can't get out. Bergeron held the puck in. Protected by Jaromir Jagr. Up the boards to the defense. Andrew Ferris throws the puck in behind. Bergeron scooped the puck to the front of the net. Seabrook was right there. They'll get it back. What a save by Corey Crawford. Just robbed Brad Marchand.
That's one way to get this crowd into the game, as Crawford makes his best save. This is the best shift by the Bruins, using aggressive down low play, good cycle game, a backhand pass, no look, a turnover, and then Jagr to Marchand, and great glove by Crawford. Good positioning, quick shot at the end of the shift as Marchand was tired, but an excellent save.
Got a lot on that for being flat-footed. McQuaid held the puck in off the draw. Peverly to Krug with his shot. Top of the save. Loose puck. And a mad scramble. Tyler Seguin comes out of it with the puck and then left it behind. Peverly battles here with Brandon Saad. Bruins are coming on here, so the Blackhawks play the puck by them and get out. Andrew Shaw throws the ball, is up, but Saad over on the left wing was a foot offside.
Well, the defense have been really effective for the Boston Bruins offensively in these playoffs. Here's another example of a hard shot by Krug, a rebound, and look at Letty trying to help his goaltender out in desperation.
15 goals from the Boston defense, 6 from the Chicago defense.
You can see that one did get through Letty, and it was the pad of Crawford that was able to make that save.
That looked like the end of the Boston-Pittsburgh
series. Yeah, did it. Bodies all over the place.
Nick Letty with a long shot in, changed direction, and Rask made the save. Letty again pinching down the boards, holds the puck in, hand pass, though will stop play.
Every faceoff is so important, and we've talked about PJ did, about Boston's prowess, but this is an exciting time. And you watch Bergeron on this faceoff, it's his stick that actually knocks the puck out to the point for a scoring chance.
Too anxious.
It's big stage, big prize.
Blackhawks won another draw in the neutral zone. Rask slows the puck up. Terrence is back. He's with Boychuk. And the fourth line's trying to break out. Long pass for Dan Paille, slipped by him. Kruger gets back, and this is the second time early in this hockey game that Boston's fourth line has iced the puck. And so quickly, Joel Quenneville changes.
Well, the one thing the Bruins aren't being able to do, like Glenn mentioned, is get the puck out easily. There's another pinch along the wall. Good support in the middle of the ice by Kelly, but a tough play under pressure ends up with this icing. So adjustment needed by the Boston Bruins. Look at Thornton. He's just wanting to get kicked out so that everybody can get a little bit of a rest.
That's just routine now, even if they're not tired.
What a big draw by Kelly to win that one on his offside.
That's why this is such a good fourth line. They can be trusted in this situation, even if they ice the puck. They've got a great center iceman on there. They're up against Taves, Hossa, and Sharp. And quickly, Chara is right back on as soon as they cleared the puck. And a match up against the Taves line.
Another mix of lines. You saw quickly Quenneville go back to Bickel and Kane, but now Sharp and Hossa back with Taves.
Long pass for Krejci, tipped it in. Chalmerson just wanted Krejci right in front. Lucic scores! They went for the big hit behind the net, and the Bruins' Krejci line strikes first. Krejci, Horton, and Lucic. And it's 1-0 Boston.
Glenn talked about it. Everybody trying to play the Bruins game. The Penguins tried to out-hit him in game one, weren't successful. Here's a great example of forget about the puck. What's the most important thing? Well, the puck is. Krejci just jumps off that hit by Jalmerson, and two quick passes later, it's in the back of the net. You have to go in with a good stick, get the puck away, not try to get the body and come up empty.
Got to give the Boston Bruins a lot of credit. It is a 1-2-2 that Chicago plays through the neutral zone, and as a result, you've got to have patience with the puck. Patience result in a result like that.
So it's Lucic from Horton and Krejci at 13-11, the first goal of the Stanley Cup Final. That's 54 points now for the Krejci line, by far and away the best line in the playoffs.
They are the dangerous one, but it's just another example of stick in the air. And first lesson of defense, you got to get the stick down and hunt the puck. And what a play by Krejci to just absorb that hit, bounce off, and then a beautiful passing play gives the Bruins their ninth first goal of this playoff.
Lucic has his fourth goal. And the Boston Bruins on the road have the lead. Bruins have won 9 of their last 10 games. The Blackhawks 7 of their last 8, including 5 in a row at home. Two teams into the final on a roll. Brent Seabrook just got bowled over. Now he's in some trouble. He's bailed out there. And an excellent defensive play by Patrick Kane to lift his stick. Otherwise, it would have been a 2-on-1. Here's Andrew Shaw, number 65, chasing the puck and hacking at Zdeno Chara. Rink-wide pass to Krejci. Jager into the middle of the ice. Lucic looking for Krejci, can't find him as Claude Julien goes right back with a Krejci line after they scored the goal. Vancouver's Milan Lucic has the first goal of the Stanley Cup Final from line mates Horton and Krejci. Chicago is the high-scoring team against the defensive team from Boston, but the Bruins have now scored 4 more goals in the playoffs, thanks to David Krejci and company, than Chicago.
Wow, and it is an amazing line. You know, you look at Horton, who's second in that list of scoring. This makes him plus 22 now. You got to go back to Yeri Kurri in 84-85 to have a plus minus like that. Third best plus minus ever since they started recording them. A dangerous line.
They're on the ice again, and Chara, off the faceoff won by Krejci, took a shot that Corey Crawford kicked aside. Here's Jonathan Toews, head-to-head with the Krejci line. Host is there, so is Brandon Saad up on this line now. Centering pass, too many Bruins in front of the net. Lucic to Horton and to Krejci. Lucic heading for the net, and the pass is knocked out of the air by Nicklas Hjalmarsson, and then he gets it himself, and the high stick will stop the play.
There's a great example of how frustrating it is to play against the Boston Bruins defense. They all collapse back to the middle of the ice. Look at the back pressure. The forwards come back. You think you have an opportunity. You got five white sweaters in that slot area. And then back the other way quickly on transition. You don't just have to deal with the likes of Chara and Seidenberg. You have to deal with the three forwards coming back as a unit.
That is swept to the boards. Adam McQuaid keeps it in for Boston. Bruins have really turned the tide since about the midway mark of this period, haven't they?
Couldn't ask for a better road period. This crowd can be so into it, and they're not.
Another centering pass was blocked before it got to the front of the net. Patrick Sharp is now out with Andrew Shaw and Dave Boland. Joel Quenneville has really mixed and matched a lot, especially for the early part of game one of the Stanley Cup final. McQuaid, Bruins come out through the middle of the ice. Brad Marchand goes wide and inside on Duncan Keith. Couldn't quite get the shot after he danced him and got by. Ferentz hustled to hold the puck in. Marchand off the boards to Jágr to Marchand. Great move, and once again he can't get the shot. But he's dangling all over the place. From the blue line, Johnny Boychuk's shot tipped in front by Peverly and stopped by Crawford. And the Blackhawks are in a little trouble here against the Bruins.
And the Bruins are playing more their style of game. They're really supporting well, short passes, and a lot of offensive zone time.
Nick Leddy is back. He's checked by Kaspers Dagovins. Latvian on the ice. 10 countries from around the world are represented in this Stanley Cup final, but mostly from Canada. 29 Canadians on the two rosters. One of them, Adam McQuaid, back for the puck. He's hit by Bolick. Centering pass to Krueger. Frolik with a shot. And he hit Bolick coming up from behind the net. The center, Reddy's a great skater. Not many players will win a race against him, and he got back for the puck. Johnny Boychuk, 5 goals, chips the puck in, and he'll forecheck while his teammates are changing, or his teammates. Bruins get in on the forecheck and stole the puck. It should have been out from the blue line. Boychuk with a shot. Ricochet just wide of the net as the Krejci line comes on here. They're playing a lot early on because they're playing so well. Pickle to Kane with Hanzus. Turned back just inside the blue line. Johnny Oduya. Nick Hjalmarsson. Left-handed shot, plays the right side. Up the middle. That's stalled in the neutral zone again.
That's 3 in a row for the Blackhawks not getting over the blue line. I'm sure Coach Quenneville won't be too happy with getting turned back the other way.
And that's more the Bruins game, isn't it? Yep. They owned the neutral zone against Pittsburgh. They did that a lot to them.
I feel they've settled into their game a little bit more than maybe the Hawks have.
Yeah, I mean, the nervous jitters, yeah. Even if you have 17 players who've been to the Cup Final before, there's still some real excitement in game number one. And the Blackhawks were fast early on. Haven't been as much in the last few minutes.
This was the line that got it when Saad was out there with Shaw. Now you've got Taves. There's a little chip and go.
Most of the regular season, this was the line that led the Blackhawks. Jonathan Taves, Marian Hossa, and rookie Brandon Saad, number 20.
Quenneville really has juggled his lines, hasn't he? Seen almost every combination.
Whoa, dangerous wink wide pass, but he got it through. Marchand, wide on his off wing. Spins again, didn't like what he saw back at the point. Now he finds Johnny Boychuk on the other side. Ferentz, his pass is tipped off a stick. Jágr protects the puck against Taves. Hossa to Brandon Saad from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Just smeagled by the check of Johnny Boychuk on the boards. Here's Dave Boland, tried to pass the puck in front of the net, didn't work. Jágr pinching is Duncan Keith, and Jágr got the puck by him to center. Rosevall is there, just about turned it over to Rich Peverly. Now up the middle, here's Dave Boland. Fakes the shot, goes wide on Ferentz, can't take the shot. Held the puck in, but on the other side, Boychuk. Out to Sagan, trying to take off up the middle, and Leddy stayed with him, knocked the puck loose. Dagovins couldn't get it following up. And back the other way. Andrew Shaw off the wing with a shot that's easily kicked out by Tukaras. Leddy pinches down the boards, held the puck in. Seidenberg trying to clear it, another pinch on the other side by Hjalmarsson. And the Bruins shot the puck by him. He didn't stop the puck, but at least he forced a Bruin icing call. Well, you can be part of our broadcast as well on Hockey Night in Canada's second screen. Use your computer, your phone, And join us at cbcsports.ca/second screen for trivia, games, and cash prizes. Bruins always seem to have a good center on the ice, even when they make a mistake and ice the puck. This time it's Peverly against Taves.
1 minute.
All the wingers come in, and the Bruins win the scramble. Seidenberg up the boards. Duncan Keith held the puck in. Nice pass. Taves turned and fired, and there was Chara to block it. Beverly, Sagan, and Dogovin's caught on the icing call. Scrambling to change now. Taves for Bickle. And along the boards, the Bruins break up the play and get the puck to send. Duncan Keith. Well, the pace is really slow late in the period, hasn't it? Favoring the road team, one would think. Chalmerson off the bench up against Lucic. Here comes David Krejci. Lucic with him along the boards. Horton in the slot. The play is broken up by Duncan Keith, and he got the puck to center ice.
What a great stick by Keith there. He was going to get deep and knocked it right out of midair.
Dying seconds of the first period. And you can hear by the reaction or lack of it in the building which team is ahead. Milan Lucic has scored the only goal of the Stanley Cup Final in Game 1, and the Bruins have the lead. Don Cherry is on site, as you saw in the opening. He and Ron McLean are along with Coach's Corner. Boston Bruins on the road have the lead on Lucic's goal on Hockey Night in Canada.
I think Boston to begin the second period of Game 1 of the Stanley Cup Final. Bruins took control of the game in the last 6 or 7 minutes, and assistant coach Doug Jarvis says if they're to keep it, they have to continue to be respectful of Chicago's speed and do a better job on the boards, as the Hawks are a heavy pinching team. Quick update on Gregory Campbell, who had surgery on Monday on his broken leg, so he couldn't make the trip to Chicago, and there's no timeline on his return, as the surgery was extensive. 6 pins required, and some bone fragments had to be removed. Campbell and his now iconic shift on the broken leg remains a source of inspiration to the Bruins, who have honored him with his own stall in the visitors' room at the United Center, even though he couldn't travel to the game. Jim?
Thank you, Scott. The first period in this one was remarkably like the first period of Game 1 against Pittsburgh for Boston, where Pittsburgh had some early pressure, got some big hits, wanted some big hits. In that game, David Krejci scored the only goal of the first period. In this one, Milan Lucic had the only goal. Boston won 55% of the faceoffs in the first period. And have the 1-0 lead on the road. Dennis Seidenberg back in his own zone. They got the puck by Marian Hossa, and it goes the distance. Chalmerson is back. Krejci's right on him. He turns the favor from the first period. There's a nifty play off the boards, and here's Jonathan Taves. Marian Hossa shoots, and Rask is there to make the save. Looked like he was trying to go 5-hole, didn't it? Bouncing puck, side of the net. Brandon Saad centering, too hot to handle for Hossa. Nathan Horton out of his own zone to center. It was Saad who made that great play off the boards to spring Taves and Hossa on the 2-on-1. So Brandon Saad banished to the third line. Now Bickle is out there. As they make a change, there's a shot and a goal. And the Boston Bruins' Milan Lucic has made it 2-0. In the midst of a Chicago change, a long change, the Bruins strike again.
Well, from bad to worse for this crowd. A great opportunity off of a nice play. As you mentioned, Saad made an excellent play in his own zone. Taves coming in all alone. Quick pass, that a nice save by Tuukka Rask. And then the Bruins, as they do so often, win the battle in the neutral zone. Lucic keeps it alive. And with Jalmerson going down, Kane is too late. And Glenn, what'd you think of that goal?
Patrick Kane stopped skating. Bad pinch. You got one of the top lines on the other team. I think Chicago has to gain a little bit more respect for this Boston team. They've kind of snuck up on them, haven't they?
Kane was fresh, too. It wasn't like he was at the end of a shift. He just started it.
Those are those battles that you just can't lose against that line particularly. That line just continues to flourish. Lucic hadn't scored in 7 games coming in, and now he's got himself a pair.
Duncan Keith shot that ricocheted wide of the net. Brent Seabrook holds the puck in. The Kane with Bolick and Hanzus. Keith again, and that's tipped just wide in front of the net. Michael Hanzus did that. Here's Patrick Kane. Takes the shot wide of the net. In behind, Bickle goes after it. Hanzus trying to wrap around up front, nothing doing. Bergeron just took his stick at center. Jágr trying to control the puck. Patrice Bergeron steps in, fires the shot. Corey Crawford made the save and drops the puck for Seabrook. At the boards, Bickle was going to leave for the bench. He stopped and got the puck to Dave Bolin. Andrew Shaw back for Bolin out of his reach. Krug stepped in and battles here. Loose puck. Patrick Sharp with a shot off the side of the net. The Bruins couldn't get the puck out. Again, they were trying to come up the boards, and Letty pinches in once again. Sharp to Bolin. Turns away from Krug. Can't get away from McQuaid. Back into Bolin, and Shaw's out front, and Bolin got hit up high. There was no signal of a penalty.
No arm up. Chris Rooney's looking, but he didn't make any kind of a motion to put his arm up. He's asking the linesman and the other official. And as you know, Bolin, a bit of an agitator, known to embellish a few times. Let's have a look what happened. No question on that one.
He's not going to get anything out of this either.
Wow.
There hasn't been a penalty in the game, and there won't be here.
Now, Glenn, I was asking you about the goaltending of Crawford early on. What do you think about this goal?
Well, he's the first one to blink. I mean, that is a rocket of a shot. But what you got to understand at the other end, Tuukka Rask has stopped 143 of 145 shots in the last five games. That's about a .986 save percentage. That's some pretty good numbers. So now you're asking your team to score three. Good luck.
Pittsburgh couldn't get three in a series against the Bruins.
It just doesn't allow, you to make a mistake, does it? And that one there, it was a quick shot and a great release up top, but it looked like Crawford a little deep in his net, maybe down a little early.
Lucic with his dad and his little brother in the building watching him has a pair in the game. Here's Paille with the drop pass. Thornton. And Crawford makes the save there.
Sharp, Taves, Kane, Bickle. First period, no shots in net. You're not going to get a goal unless you get a shot. At about the 9:08 mark of that first period, well, that's when the Boston Bruins started to play. They outshot the Chicago Blackhawks 7-2. They outscored them 1-0. It is now 2-0, and the hits are even. They were all Chicago early. Chicago had best start playing.
That Krejci line again.
Don't you think it's the speed, too? You got to get your legs moving. Keep the puck going forward.
Krejci got the draw with some help from Lucic. Chara in for David Krejci. This line now has 21 goals in the playoffs. 56 points out against them. Brandon Saad with Hossa and Taves. Saad can't drive wide on Seidenberg. Nathan Horton back in support. But there's Marian Hossa to Saad. Quick shot, he scores! Also won the battle, and Brandon Saad has his first National Hockey League playoff goal just when his team needed it most.
Well, that's one way to turn a game around and get the crowd ignited. Saad keeps the play alive. Horton with a lazy play defensively and just a rocket of a shot. Glenn, you said how compact and solid Rask was. Well, this is just a perfectly placed shot. A quick release up and over his glove.
Turnover two by the Boston Bruins made in the offensive zone. You've got to manage the puck. So quick, Chicago can turn things around on you. They're a gifted team with the pill.
Joel Quenneville, recognizing that his team wasn't going as well as he wanted, gets Brandon Saad back with the line he played with all season, and he gets his first playoff goal. And here they come again. Keith with a shot deflected into the corner. Jágr just pushed the puck ahead. Bergeron's after it. Duncan Keith, such a great skater, gets back, but the puck hits the referee. Loose puck in front of the net. And the Blackhawks recover and get out.
What a break that was.
No kidding. Here's Seabrook with a shot off the wing, and Tuukka Rask makes the save and hangs on. After all that work to get back, Duncan Keith just about suffered a terribly bad turnover against the official.
Right on the skate of Brad Watson, and it just about, you can see Watson loses sight of the puck for a split second. He's watching the play come to him, and what a battle there as Bergeron almost got around Keith. You can see the right leg stopped it. Keith responded, and a lucky break for the Hawks.
Unfortunate, he's not even looking at the puck.
Yeah.
looking to see who he's going to get bowled over by.
Boland's waved out. Sharp has to come in. Sharp now playing on the third line with Shaw and Boland. And the Blackhawks get the draw. Roosevelt intentionally wide of the net, and the puck's on the mesh. And that's where it'll stay.
But successive shifts now that the Blackhawks, with a little bit more jump in their step, getting in and creating some turnovers and loose pucks. You think of the success the teams have had, the limited success anyways, against these Bruins, is getting in quickly. There's a good battle down low. Look at how quick the support of Boland is. Shaw trying desperately to get that puck off the side of the net.
Shaw and Boland do exactly what they should do on that shift. Both pesky, both intense. Agitating.
Right to the net. Sharp got a quick shot, and Rask had to make an excellent save. This game is just about tied up, and then Sharp's taken to the boards by McQuaid.
Just a reaction save by Rask, and a very difficult play for Sharp with a bouncing puck. He just takes a swat at it. You heard in the pregame talk, Joel Quenneville talk about wingers follow the puck and get involved. Well, there's a perfect example of it there. As Sharp in knocks that one out of midair, and then the battle's on behind the net.
Boy, that could have changed this game in a real hurry.
As a goalie, you always are aware when there's a right-hand draw on the left-hand side, and Beverly's going to pull it back to the goaltender.
Shaw going at Chara now. That's what the fans are reacting to at the bottom of your screen.
It's not even a fair fight.
He once wanted to fight Hal Gill in a game, so it tells you what he's made of. May not be the smartest thing, but he's not afraid. And Krejci's waved out against Boland. Boland tried to go straight ahead against Bergeron, won the draw. Shaw got a good hit on Seidenberg, keeping the crowd in it. Here's Patrice Bergeron, lost his footing as he twisted and turned, and he pretzeled himself into the ice. Krejci. Bergeron's heading off to let Horton come on. Krug decides to pinch, and he gets a big hit. Big hit on Shaw. He's given a few, and he's taken a few. Now he wants to get one back, and he tried to get Krejci, and he got a little piece of him in the corner.
Now, if you're not going to get the puck, that's what you have to do with the body. Totally eliminate it.
Nick Hjalmarsson. Johnny Oduya shoots the puck in. A crazy bounce to the slot. Frolik can't control it, but the Blackhawks have it. Kruger with a shot into the corner. Duncan Key, Frolik with a shot as a stick came up and deflected that off the glass. Blackhawks off a crazy bounce off the stanchion have control here because of it. Marcus Kruger with Frolik and Boling. Boling trying to barge his way to the front of the net. Nathan Horton to the boards, lost that little battle to the net again. Boland, backhand shot, might get a forehand. Here's Frolik, and he shot just wide of the net. Frolik gets the puck back to the blue line. Duncan Keith, screen shot, hit the screen, then off the glass. Krejci twisted around. The Blackhawks win another board battle, and the puck was swept to Milan Lucic to Nathan Horton and back. Lucic holds up, now he hangs on and shoots. And the puck was stopped by Corey Crawford. Big battle behind the play at the benches. Here's a hard shot by Zdeno Chara that was blocked in front of the net. Now it's the Bruins' turn. Milan Lucic to Horton. He was checked before he could get the shot. Marian Hossa got to it. Chara at center ice. Brandon Saad took a run at him. Duncan Keith flushed out, so he played the puck to his partner. Slowly back to him, and Keith just cleared it in a hurry. With the puck, Dennis Seidenberg to Zdeno Chara. Up the middle. Here's Tyler Seguin against a stickless defenseman, Seabrook. Paille off the side of the net trying to center. Crawford's trying to get the puck as Seabrook cleared out Tyler Seguin. And the pace of the game is picked up once again. Blackhawks are right back in it, down 2-0. Brandon Saad scored the goal to make it a one-goal game on Hockey Night in Canada. Too small to play in the NHL after this.
The compete level for him and the element of surprise there. Shaw looking at the puck, wasn't expecting the big body. At the defensive end, a good chance in front for Boland, and Rask gets some help from Krug as well.
Tough shift for McQuaid. Watch this shot block. This hurts. Ouch. In the hand. And as he's making his way off, He gets to the Chicago bench and Hossa runs him over,
which absolutely enrages all the fans at Sam's Bar in Cornwall are tuned in tonight to watch their homeboy, Prince Edward Island. Jonathan Toews in his own zone, doesn't get out. Hoychuk kept the puck. Brad Marchand, Jaromir Jagr looking to protect the puck against Jonathan Toews. Up the boards, Marchand gives it back to Jagr. Too many Hawks around him, and out comes Marian Hossa. And inside, Hawks goal score, dumps the puck in, Ferentz overskated it, Toews to the front of the net. That was a bounce off a defenseman, Toews again, what a save by Rask. Got back in position after he was out of it. Here's Hossa to the blue line, that was tipped. And Hjalmarsson is chased out to center ice. Close call, almost tied. Duncan Keith at the blue line, just onside. Brandon Saad, Hossa shoots, Rask to save. Hossa again. Ferentz can bump him, but can't stop him. Hossa up the boards, finally stripped of the puck by Krejci, then he gets it back again, holds it in. Hanzus walks to the net, and his stick check. Duncan Keith centering, Pickle with a shot, that was blocked as the Blackhawks buzz the Bruins again. A stretch pass, David Krejci stops up, can't shoot, hits Chara, in he comes, and the play is stopped. There's an interference call in front of the net, and it'll go against Nathan Horton of the Bruins.
Well, frantic action as the Chicago Blackhawks have a great shift offensively. That Jonathan Toews been so frustrated in this playoffs. He gets a great chance off of a rebound. Tuukka Rask with an excellent save and then followed it across. Glenn's showed many a shot blocked by the Boston Bruins. Another great example. Ferentz getting himself in position, putting his body down and not allowing Pickle to get through. And then back at the other end, Horton going hard to the net. Ends up with an interference call.
So the first power play of this game goes to Chicago, and Kane's in front of the net, a loose puck. Brandon Saad kicks it back. Patrick Sharp with the blue line on the other side. Nick Leddy on the second power play unit. Kane with a shot that was blocked. Both of these teams have excelled at penalty killing, not so much on the power play during the playoffs. Up the middle, Nick Leddy. Gets the puck deep, gets after it himself, up against Zdeno Chara. Peverly's back there, but he lost his stick from the blue line. Sharp with a shot, knocked down in front of the net, and Dennis Seidenberg clears the puck. The Bruins did not give up a power play goal in the series against Pittsburgh.
Wow. And, too many men.
Too many men on a shorthanded change.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about this, even though they have too many men on the ice. The puck is, it just hits him. It's not like he played the puck.
We're going to get an argument from Bo Julian, that's for sure. But you're right, Glenn. A lot of times, even if you get in the way and impede a player, you'll get called. This one here, I think just the fact that the puck did hit the player who was coming off. He's saying he's right there. You be the judge. Four guys, here comes the man on.
And the puck hits him.
Yeah, you got to call it. He's... That puck would be up to a Chicago Blackhawk player, Kane, if it doesn't hit. Instead, it goes back the other way.
It might have been a scoring chance, yeah. Shorthanded.
That's
too.
A good call.
So 5-on-3 for a minute, 17 seconds. And the first power play unit is rested, and Toews wins the draw. Hossa back on the point along with Duncan Keith. Marian Hossa, Patrick Kane is over on the left side. Toews in front of the net, Sharps on the right side. The pass comes back to Keith, the bouncing puck, he has to settle it down. Two defensemen and a forward out there for Boston. And the forward, Patrice Bergeron, made a great play, didn't get the puck. Keith, side of the net, Keith again, fires a shot, and it deflected out of play. Down to 50 seconds left in the 5-on-3.
Well, the Boston Bruins have been dynamite the last nine games. 93.5%, 29 for 31. And on this play, you're just trying to eliminate the one-timer for Marian Hossa. You can see the head on a swivel by Bergeron, and he does a nice job of anticipating that quick pass by Duncan Keith. Seidenberg loses his stick as he broke it. That gives the penalty killers a little rest.
Yeah, I think that hard shot went off his stick, so he got a change. But that was Chris Rooney, the referee there, telling him not to take an hour and a half to get a new stick.
Sharp shoots the wrong way to be on this 5-on-3. A right-hand shot to the left of the goalie. He's not even in play if I'm in the net. I'm worrying about all the other guys. It's really a 4-on-3.
Yeah.
Kane leads the way. Taves right beside him. Hard around the board, Sharp. Decides not to relay to the blue line. Tara's right after him and he fell down. He gets back up to the front of the net. Duncan Keith now closes in on Chris Kelly. Marian Hossa, Duncan Keith. Hossa, still no shot. Hossa looks around, plays the puck to Sharp. In front of the net, Rask tipped that away. And a lucky bounce got away from Duncan Keith out to center. Remember, it's a long change for these penalty killers in this second period. Still 5-on-3 for just 5 more seconds. Nathan Horton set to come back on. Kane, DeHosa, Keith. One penalty's over. Keith, side of the net. They can't get much of a shot. Sharp was on the other side, couldn't get it away. Hossa to Keith. Hossa again, fanned on the shot, but it was blocked as it fluttered towards Kelly. Kane off the boards. Taves is down to the goal line. Sharp's on the other side now. And he takes the pass. One-timer, Rask read it perfectly and got over and made the save. Jonathan Taves skipped on Patrick Kane. And that's a gift for the penalty killers who badly needed a change. And they're down to the last 10 seconds of the second penalty for too many men on the ice. Just one shot on the 5-on-3 as the puck is dumped in by Nick Leddy. Penalty's over. Thornton serving it is back on. And now 17 straight penalty kills for the Boston Bruins since they started the last series against Pittsburgh. And they still lead 2-1. Brandon Saad picked off. Dan Pailler's trying to get away. Following the play, the puck is poked loose by Thornton. He couldn't get away from Leddy. And the puck hit another Bruin coming across the boards at the bench. There's Brad Marchand just coming on, but he wasn't on the ice. Well, Sharp got a chance. He wasn't on that right side where he was initially lined up. He was in a great shooting position, and he fanned on it. On Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. Chuck, not Ferentz. Heels is going to look at the mighty Krug.
This guy's got to play when Chara kills all 2 minutes of a penalty. 5:36, 10 shifts. Who says he couldn't play in the league? Great offensive skills. Watch him with his head up here. Almost an empty net to Seguin. Good stick. You've got to be smart if you're 5'8". When they bring you the puck, you take it off him.
He's 5'9". Come on.
You know, in game 4, I thought he was extending some of his shifts. He had an average shift length of almost a minute. I'm sure he had a little discussion with the head coach there. He's down to 33 seconds here in game 1.
In comes Jaromir Jagr for Boston. A hard pass to the front of the net went off Duncan Keith's skate. Jagr gets to the puck again. Into the middle for Marchand. He had to knock the puck down, couldn't control it. Ferentz holds it in. Cleared away. Ferentz again at the blue line. Keeps the puck in for Bergeron. He slipped the check from Seabrook. Jagr. Marchand couldn't control it. Boychuk to the net. Crawford had to make a save. Bruins turn for some pressure after a great 5-on-3 penalty kill. Boychuk with a shoot in. Both teams change on the clock. Shots are 17-17. Bruins have a pair of goals from Milan Lucic. Brandon Saad has scored for Chicago. He's on the ice and headed for the net. And Hossa wanted that rebound picked up, but every man in front was picked up. Chalmerson to Brandon Saad. His pass for Hossa missed. David Krejci shoots the puck back in. Crawford knocks it down. Nicholas Chalmerson. Outlet to center. Hossa battles for the puck and gets it. Backhand centering pass, and the Bruins get that. Horton off the boards to Milan Lucic. Krejci's coming with him up the middle. Horton's coming up late. So is it. And O'Chara, he takes the pass, puts the puck at the net. Chalmerson blocked it. Chara tried to stay, but had his stick lifted by Hossa. How hard would that be to do? Dave Bolin with a shot. Rebound! And Brandon Saad was there, just about had his second late in his shift, but he couldn't get the rebound. Lucic to center. Michael Rosenvall is back. Quickly up the middle, here's Sharp. Shaw goes to the net. Sharp shot, stopped by Rask. And there's going to be a penalty on the boards here. And who's going to get it?
The Bruins are going to go to their first power play, it appears. Zdeno Chara was arguing earlier on. And he's the one going up.
It's Chara who's going to go.
Watch the play. A nice shot to create a rebound that Chara battles to get back. Saad had a great chance. There's the penalty. Oh, the head back. I was watching the play on the boards. It looked like a hook. So after a 5-on-3 that went nowhere, the Chicago Blackhawks are 1 for their last 20 on the power play.
That's hard to imagine, isn't it? And they've already failed on a 5-on-3 of a minute and 17 seconds. Now they've got Andrew Shaw to the right side here with Jonathan Taves and Patrick Kane, Duncan Keith and Brent Seabrook. Kane, side of the net. Taves returned the puck to Patrick Kane. For Taves, Shaw is parked in front of the net. Taves spins off a check. Seabrook, round the outside for the Blackhawks. Taves, Kane with a shot. Rask with a save. Keith can't control the rebound, but his skating got back with the puck, and then Kelly knocked him over. And here's the puck, and the Bruins take advantage of that to change. Seabrook leaves the puck for Duncan Keith. The rush to power play to center. He made a pass. Too many Bruins lined up across the blue line. And they gain possession, and Marchand sends the Hawks back.
I don't understand that entry. You've got all the speed coming up the ice with Keith, who delivers it to a guy standing still on the line, and Taves with two guys next to him.
Nick Letty's pass up the middle line. The Bruins pick it off in the neutral zone. Brad Marchand just about got by Letty, and then the puck was stripped away from him.
I think Boston does really well. Their sticks are always in the right lanes. Even if they're not physically
like
there, they defend with the stick almost as much as where they are physically.
Just as Krejci did there. Letty. Hossa. With Saad and Boland. Sharp falls in behind Boland, takes the pass. Protects the puck, throws it around, but Hossa had to scramble and he couldn't get to the puck. And Paye looks behind and knows he's got some help, and he tried to feed Krejci, but Letty's skate blocked it.
Well, isn't it amazing when you don't have confidence as a group on the power play? It just, everything seems so forced, and right now it is for Chicago.
Kane to Taves, hit the side of the net. Roosevelt in deep. Here's Taves, got a fortuitous bounce. And a deflection kept the puck away from Oduya in his shooting position. Penalty's over. Chara, one of the best penalty killers, is back on. And the Boston Bruins in the Stanley Cup playoffs have now killed 18 straight penalties. Against Pittsburgh and Chicago, two great offensive teams.
Hard to believe both could be struggling so mightily on their power plays, isn't it?
You can win a cup without a power play, but if you don't have penalty killing,
yeah,
you have no chance.
Both teams have plenty of that. Johnny Oduya in his own zone.
10 times Chicago had to kill a penalty when the game was on the line against Detroit when they were down 3-1. How'd that work out for them?
Well, they're here.
Worked out pretty good. The only time their power play came to life was games 5 and 6 in that Detroit series to get themselves back.
Well, for the Bruins, it looked like in the Rangers series, they were finally going to have a power play in the playoffs, but then they reverted to their old selves. Glenn talked about the great sticks of the Boston Bruins, always in the right position. On a penalty kill, that might have saved an opportunity to score against Brandon Saad. First round, Tuukka Rask always seems to be on a shutout streak. The latest one that ended with the goal by Brandon Saad went 149 minutes and 39 seconds.
Look at the last 5 games, a 981 save percentage. You know, the engraver for the Conn Smythe trying to figure out how to spell Tuukka, because he's the guy who may win it. Look at that. That's, you don't see that. Using your stick to make sure there's no rebound. Most goaltenders now just stop, let the puck hit your pads, give up a rebound. Not him.
He used to be irascible, and now he's unflappable. He just looks so calm.
Just don't go to a shootout in the playoffs. That's all I say.
Yes.
Everything else, he's fine.
Seldom in the last couple of years has the United Center been library-like. Hossa on Seidenberg. And this will be an icing call against the Boston Bruins. So they won't be able to change, but have a pretty good line on the ice. Krejci.
Back to Rask during the national anthem, guys. I watched him in warm-up. He looked different than he looked in the last series. And in this series, again, Stanley Cup final, this is your first crack at it. Ho-hum, this is easy. I'll find a way to get it done. You know, you look at those numbers, they're really special considering it's against the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Nolan came out and won the draw. Krejci came out and got the puck. And Duncan Keith is forced back into his own zone. Drops for Patrick Kane. He attacks the blue line with speed, takes a shot. Rask the save, rebound cleared by Chara to the boards. Lucic against Bickle. Into the middle, Kane gets a hold of the puck, dumps it in. Chara there to reject it again. Lucic has got both Boston goals out to center. Seabrook to Kane. He relays to Hanzus. To Bickle, it was in his feet. As a battle to get the puck back, and then he gave it up to Bergeron up the middle. That was going to spring a two-on-one. And Bickle stepped in front of Jaromir Jagr. Zdeno Chara. Bergeron tried to find Marchand again. Stopped in the neutral zone, and Boland dumps the puck in. Boland sharpens Shaw. They're offside. They have to tag up. So Johnny Boychuk gets out through center. Bouncing puck. Taken by Roosevelt, deep in his own zone. Boston changed on the fly. Sharp tipped the puck in and got it again. Goes deep against Ferentz. Takes the man. Shaw looking for the puck. Ferentz got hit, but he still made the play up the boards. And Kelly clears the puck through center. Here's Sagan. And there was a check in the corner, but the puck wasn't touched. And when it was by the Blackhawks, it's an icing call.
Well, Glenn, going back to the Pittsburgh series, a lot of times what you found with the stars of the Penguins was one against three or four. It happened to Sidney Crosby, it happened to Malkin. Here, Kane gets a little bit of daylight, but it's one shot and out again. And too often, that's the way their defensive system is stifling. They take away your time and space. And when frustration sets in, that's when you start cheating, and they take advantage of it on transition.
Taves got the draw, Hossa got the shot, Rask makes the save, and there'll be another faceoff after that icing call, but now Boston can change, and Chara comes on because it's a defensive zone faceoff.
That's the importance of just even one call by a referee. Now, Letty's flat-footed here. Sagan's got all the speed in the world. I get that Letty touches the puck first, but he held him up. Sagan's clear to that puck. He's got a full head of steam. And puck's dropped. Faceoff's won by Chicago. You need Rask to make a big save. It's a fine line in the series.
Taves won the draw. Chalmerson with a shot snatched out of the air by Tuukka Rask for another faceoff.
And in game four for the Bruins series against Pittsburgh, that was a penalty, right?
Totally.
A little body contact there. So, once again, the hybrid icing or whatever you want to call it. Some confusing moments.
Taves got the puck back, but the winger Lucic jumped up. Got a hold of the puck, couldn't quite get it out. Chalmerson takes a shot blocked by Bergeron. He's got it caught up in his paraphernalia.
Yeah, that one hurt. It got caught up underneath his pants, but you can see right at the top of your knee where your shin pad doesn't cover everything. You can see a little discomfort there. You turn the puck over, you get in, and you're up right on the top of the knee. And fortunate for him, it stayed up there, and he was able to get a faceoff. But you lose now Bergeron for this important drop.
They're so deep in center ice, though. Kelly comes on, Krejci's there. There's the puck dropping out of the pants of Bergeron. So Kelly comes in.
21st shot block, guys, for the Boston Bruins.
And Kelly did his job. He came on and won the draw, but he's going to have to win another one because Boston's iced the puck again with 1:20 to go in the second period.
This is another tough call, too, because Chalmerson, the defenseman's pinching in here, and often when you see the puck coming around and the D-man pinches, you don't get an icing. So another chance, right off the draw, puck's alive, Seidenberg just throws it away.
Bruins get another draw, Kelly over to the puck, he'll go back the other way, Hossa read that, picked it off, trying to get out front, he's got two Bruins on him, Saad comes in support, kicked the puck up the boards, the Bruins got it instead of Jonathan Taves. And finally, Boston's out of its own zone. Lucic dumps the puck in, goes after Chalmerson, gets the hit, but Chalmerson was ready for that. Taves back. Brandon Saad turned back into his own zone, just about got himself in some trouble against Krejci. Johnny Oduya with a hard outlet pass, and now it's Chicago. They've iced the puck in. Taves has got to stay. He saw it, and Kane are on there, and two-thirds of that line's been on for a while.
Jonathan Taves having a good night in the faceoff circle. 10-6 for 63%, but here late in the period, a really important draw, and Bergeron is back on, and he's on his strong side.
Taves takes his time, gets his stick down on his knees, catches his breath, and comes in for the faceoff. He got the draw. Taken away in front of the net. Marchand couldn't get the shot. Topped at the net. Marchand trying to come up with it. This is off a draw that Chicago won, but the wingers jumped and Boston got possession. Now Ferentz can't hold the puck in against Kane. Brad Marchand to Patrice Bergeron. Wouldn't that have been a killer if Boston been able to score there off that faceoff? They return back from the blue line. Ferentz this time whips a shot towards the net, kicked away by Johnny Oduya. Taves, who's had a marathon shift, make that Bickle now, stops up, can't get the puck to the net. Taves got the change, Bickle got the shot, period comes to an end, and Boston leading by one after the first period, leads by a goal after the second. Milan Lucic has a pair of goals, and Brandon Saad has the only goal for Chicago. Dennis Seidenberg in conversation with Scott Oak, and the crew's not in 42. They're here at the United Center tonight. Our studio show is next on Hockey Night in Canada with the Blackhawks trailing at home in game one of the Stanley Cup Final.
Inside the building as a forecast storm seemed to be moving in, but now it seems the worst part of that storm has missed Chicago. There were reports before the game that some parts of the city were without power, and a power outage in this building was on the NHL's worry list. With the weather turning, they opened the doors to the building early tonight so that fans would be safe, warm and dry. And the doors open early on a humid night might have had something to do with ice conditions and a lot of bouncing pucks tonight, Jim.
There was a power outage, but it was Chicago's 5-on-3, and that was about it. You're really good at doing the weather now. Thanks, Dave DeVol.
Yeah, he's doing an excellent job.
Jaromír Jágr used to do the weather in Pittsburgh, and it was very simple. For today, hot. For today, cold.
Here come the Bruins with the lead. Lucic for the hat trick. They're stopped on a Jonathan Taves blocked shot. That's the way the Bruins wanted to start this period, but not so much the Hawks, trailing at home by a goal in the first game of the Stanley Cup Final. Long pass up the middle for Brandon Saad. He's back with Hossa and Taves, and he has been since very early in the game. This is a line that played together most of the regular season. And Joel Quenneville, do you think, guys, that he's mad at somebody, or is it seeking balance? Why has he juggled his line so much tonight?
Yeah, it seems to be a bit of a combination of both, trying to see what Claude Julien wants, and but also certain players. Glenn, you feel that's one of his targets, Bickle not having the kind of game he needs out of him, huh?
And, you know, you look at guys like Hossa, six shots. You look at this entire Chicago team, they've got twice as many shot attempts as the Boston Bruins, but not from the right guys. Host is the only big boy who's stepping it up offensively.
Bickle took his man with Johnny Boychuk so that the puck could get by and the Blackhawks could get to the attacking zone. Kane on Marchand back supporting his defense. Bruins will try the right side to get out. A pass up the middle. Missed Patrice Bergeron and deflected off Seabrook. Boston's changing, so is Chicago. Duncan Keith. Patrick Kane out of his reach on a collision course with Torrey Krug. Spun away from the check. Needs Duncan Keith. There's a crowd in front. The shot goes into it, but the seas parted enough for Tuukka Rask to make the save.
One thing we've talked a lot about is the intelligence of Rask and knowing when the team needs a faceoff. Here you got a matchup where Krug and McQuaid are out against Kane at the end of the shift, a bit of a change. So instead of allowing the play to continue, does an excellent job of absorbing that and allowing his coach to get a change.
Not all goalies pay attention to who's on the ice, do they, Glenn?
No, there's a lot of guys that Mike Richter, I played with, had no idea. We talk about all the players before games. We talked to him about Matt Sundin from Toronto, and Matt scored two breakaway goals on him. And then the intermission, Mike asked me, who's that guy got the two breakaways on me? Matt Sundin, the captain. Might want to pay attention to that. He's pretty good.
Rich Cleverly checked as he tried to make a pass off the boards, and the Blackhawks are back through center. Nick Leddy, puck almost got away from it. Tough to control on pretty wet ice right now. Very humid day in Chicago. There's a long pass for Tyler Seguin. One goal in the playoffs on 56 shots.
You're just wondering when he's going to break out.
Looked at times in the Pittsburgh series like he was ready to. Andrew Shaw's in after the puck. Marcus Kruger, number 16. Patrick Sharp there as well on another different looking line. Now Frolik comes on to join them. Frolik and Kruger haven't had much ice time tonight. Chase in the game, the fourth line for Chicago, hasn't played as much.
Well, you see the Hawks trying to pinch their defense too. You got to be careful there in the transition game of Boston. Oduya almost got caught and created a two-on-one the other way.
Oduya dumped the puck in. He had nowhere to go in the neutral zone. Here's a chance for Krejci, and the play is stopped on a hand pass. Knocked out of the air with a hand.
Well, we've talked about guys that have disappointed Coach Quenneville. Well, one guy who hasn't and has been a factor all game long, recognizes the Stanley Cup final, been an agitator, gets in the kitchen of the captain, jumps off a faceoff, big hits. Now you need more of that level of energy from the rest of your players. And there's a line that's on the ice now that can do exactly that with the puck. And they need to get some goals from it.
Tave, Saad, Hossa in the attacking zone. Krejci to take the faceoff for Boston. Hossa gets it along the boards, but the puck got away from him, and Seidenberg moved it up. Horton can't get out along the boards. Three Blackhawks are there. Krejci is back in support to Horton, and now he's skating away to center. Line mates have changed. Well, one of them had. Here's Krejci. To Seidenberg. Walks the line, then passes down to Krejci to the front of the net. Horton couldn't get the puck. Lucic had his stick check. And Jonathan Taves gets the puck out to center. Brandon Saad, 20-year-old from Pittsburgh, dumps the puck in. Zdeno Chara, rink wide. Horton had to stop to get the puck. Krejci in support, tripped up by Patrick Kane. And Horton dumps the puck in.
Krejci looking to get a call there. He wanted a penalty. Not going to happen.
Bruins haven't had a power play in the game. Here's Michael Hanzus to the net. And once again, Rask is there, makes an easy save, and there won't be a second chance.
Well, here's another example of the Bruins' just frustrating style of play. You know you got to push the game. You know you got to try to get pucks to the net. But too often, much like the Pittsburgh series so far early on, lots of attempts on net, but none of those second and third opportunities in front of Tuukka Rask.
Put it in perspective, Craig, the Boston Bruins have missed the net one time all game long.
It really helps, not only that Rask pays attention to the game, but that he can catch.
Yep.
There's a pass up the middle, and Marchand had a breakaway, but he couldn't control the puck. Crawford fell as he played the puck into the corner. Here's Brian Bickle. His pass was nowhere near Kane, and the Bruins dump it back over the blue line. Kane, Keith, Seabrook, to Bickle through the neutral zone. Kane, lots of passing. Here's Keith with his shot. And once again, Tuukka Rask makes sure there's no second chance as Brad Marchand pushed Duncan Keith down and Seabrook came in.
He better be careful he doesn't push his luck. You saw Crawford go down in the Chicago end. Guess he was a part of that one, number 63, like he's done so many times. Just a little foot on foot. Here's the puck race. Now you're going by. Just get in there. Yep, little toe on toe. And then he's tempting fate here. After the whistle goes, he gets back on it. And ever the agitator is Brad Marchand.
But that's where your focus gets taken away from the real part of the game that matters, which is, don't worry about Marchand. What you've got to worry about is Tuukka Rask. You've got to get bodies in front of the net. The past two saves, one by Hanzus, easily stoppable, barely going 50K an hour, and the last one in front of the net, again, no screen, easy save.
Patrick Sharp to Dave Bolin. His shot off the wing was blocked. In front of the net is Shaw, and there's Rask again, stopping the play before the Hawks could get the puck to the front of the net.
When there is traffic, the one thing that Rask does really well, because of his size, because of his agility, athleticism, looks around. Puck's not going to go to my left, so where's he got to go? I'll play the percentage. Has to go to the right. Quick look to the left. Stronger move to the right. Easy save.
Boland against Peverly, and Rich Peverly won the faceoff. Adam McQuaid to Tyler Seguin, and he tipped the puck out of his own zone. Nick Leddy will start the breakout. Look at the Bruins. They've backed off into the neutral zone again. Cut off the middle of the ice. Make the Blackhawks come up the boards and get the puck in. McQuaid is back. Taken out hard by Boland. And Sharp is there looking for the puck. Shaw right there as well. Andrew Shaw trying to curl to the net off the boards. The puck was stripped away from him. Leddy kept the play onside for the Blackhawks. Sharp off the boards, turns and fires. That came off Rask, and Boland gets to the puck. In for Shaw. He had his stick checked by McQuaid. Puck squirts loose. Tory Krug to Kasper's Dogovins, and there's a defenseman pinching again. Leddy, and holds the puck in for Chicago. On the other side, Shaw gets the hit on McQuaid. Bruins, though, get the puck and out to center. Peverly just decides to dump it in. He had Dogovins with him.
This game is not for the faint of heart. McQuaid twice knew he was going to get cream, still made the play.
Here's Jonathan Toews with a shot off the wing. A harmless one stopped by Rask. Toews takes a shift here with Bolick and Michael Frolik as the line juggling continues. Chara tripped up, and here comes the Boston Bruins' first power play of the night. And the new line didn't look too good as Michael Frolik takes a penalty and Boston goes to the power play.
Boy, tough timing for the Blackhawks too after a great shift. If the Bruins are going to stand up at the line, you have to have speed to get in and retrieve pucks. Shaw does one thing and one thing only, separate the man from the puck, does another job on later, and McQuaid's having to pay the price to make a play. And after three really good plays, stick between the legs and Chara goes down. That's a tough call to have when you're 200 feet from your own net, giving the Bruins an opportunity to spread the lead.
Especially if you're on the fourth line, you played four shifts in the second, and that's your first in the third.
And you're the number one penalty killer on the team, along with Marcus Kruger. Boston 0 for 13 in the power play against Pittsburgh. Chicago has killed 24 of the last 26 power plays they've faced. Bruins, Tyler Seguin passes off. What a shot. What a goal. Patrice Bergeron hammered the shot on a pass from Tyler Seguin, and Boston has a power play goal to lead 3-1.
And what a long skate for Frolik to go from the box back to his bench. Bergeron's been a game breaker all playoffs. Couple of big overtime game-winning goals. Here's a opportunity for Keith to get the puck out. He can't. A nice pass by Seguin, and nobody's stopping that. Just a perfect blast with a one-timer off the post and in.
Plays finished by Bergeron, but it started for Bergeron too. This guy does it all the time. Face-off win, help from your wingers. Quenneville talked about how good Boston was on the face-offs, how they needed wingers to jump. Didn't happen there. Ends up in the back of the net.
Lucic got a second assist. He just about got his third goal right there on a shot with his team up 3-1. There's a centering pass now. Here's Lucic again. Boston in control of the game, up 3-1. Seidenberg stripped of the puck by Brandon Saad. Chara, Krejci, and a tip hit. Duncan Keith is back.
Now you're going to see five Bruins above the puck at every turn. Check, check, check into the ground in the neutral zone.
That's how they're built. They're built as a shutdown team. Whether it's Bergeron or Chara, they're not wired for offense, even though
they don't get enough credit for how skilled they are offensively. When they do make you turn the puck over, they finish.
Well, this is a good example. This little guy here.
Another shot by Patrice Bergeron blocked. Patrick Kane trying to get away from Marchand, who's chopping away at him. The puck's thrown to the net. Roseval, a defenseman in deep. There's a 3-on-2 at center, broken up for a second by Oduya. Rich Peverly. Got Yager trailing. Patrick Sharp. And he flips the puck out to center. Dave Boland chasing Adam McQuaid. Long pass up the middle. Just onside now. Here's Andrew Shaw in front. Boland scores! The best players early in the game and have given Chicago some life. Boland from Shaw.
Well, rookie mistake on the back end and an opportunity to just get the puck out along the boards. Instead, Krug tries to go backing up through the middle of the ice. Shaw makes an excellent play and an even better pass. He delayed at the line so it wouldn't be offside. Had good patience with the puck, head up the entire time and slid it underneath Krug to a wide open Boland.
Big goal, a minute 51 seconds after the power play goal by Bergeron, his sixth. Put Boston up 3-1. The Blackhawks get some life. And we'll see how they do. First shift after a goal. Kolek was after the puck. And he loved to make amends for the penalty he took. Boychuk to Ferris. Long pass for Dan Pae up against Chalmerson. Sagan trying to fight in to get the puck against Nick Leddy. Bouncing puck. Pae had a swipe at it. Boychuk holds the puck in. Pae let it go. Kelly couldn't come up with it. Kolek keeping his own zone, played the puck back. Now Nick Leddy from Chalmerson. Long shot from center. Rask makes an easy save. Seidenberg got for the puck. He hit his own teammate trying to clear the puck, and the Blackhawks got it back. Get Lucic in the seat of the pants trying to get the puck up the boards. There's another turnover. Hosa with a shot. Rebound. Saad with a shot. That's blocked. Roosevelt holds the puck in. Marian Hosa to the front of the net. Bouncing puck off Rask. Roosevelt gets it. And he lost control and he fell down. And here comes Lucic to David Krejci. Back to Lucic. Stopped by Crawford. Thrown in front. Horton turns. Fires. With no goaltender in the net. Hosa was going to try and make a save. And the Blackhawks dodge a bullet there for the moment. Johnny Oduya has some time now. Boston's changing on the fly. Patrick Kane picks up speed, darts through the neutral zone. Puck swept away by Zdeno Chara. From behind the net, the centering pass by Hanjus was blocked. Rushing to the puck is Seabrook. Can't hold it in. And it bounced off the shin guard of Brad Marchand to center. Bergeron rushes onto a loose puck. Hanjus trying to track him down along the boards. Yager is there as well. A bouncing puck. Bergeron's got it. His shot was blocked by Seabrook. Yager can't get control. Blackhawks do. Sharp got the puck to center and starts a change. Brad Marchand back in on his off wing. Puck didn't come outside the line, but the Blackhawks got it anyway. Seabrook to Kane. Seabrook to the net. Trying to protect the puck from Peverly. A centering pass went off a leg and Bickle couldn't take it cleanly. Yager won't go after this loose puck that drifts into the Chicago zone because he was going to change, but it's an icing call and now he can't. And will this draw the Boston Bruins timeout?
Well, big momentum swing here as the Bruins could have just quieted this crowd down with the top line again. A little saucer pass for Lucic. Had to adjust to get the one-timer off. Didn't get all of it, but a good toe save by Crawford keeps this a one-goal game.
Brad Marchand just tried to change his stick in an effort to get a little bit extra time. Denied by the referee.
And they didn't use the timeout. Chicago won the draw. Andrew Ferentz got a hold of the puck, trying to clear it. Chalmerson won't let him, keeps it in. Ferentz is taken out hard, a centering pass in escape. Leddy takes the shot. That went off a body wide of the net. Bickle gets to the puck, and he crossed up his defenseman, Chalmerson. So the puck comes out, and the Blackhawks have to tag up. Bruins trying to get a quick change in here. They got a couple of guys off. Now they're trying to get out of their own zone. Boychuk ran up against Bickle along the boards. The puck comes out to Nick Leddy. Right off the bench, here comes Seabrook. He shoots. blocked before it got through to the net. Bickle, Seabrook again, Shaw battling hard in front of the net. Ryan Bickle to his backhand, slides the puck in front, and Boychuk stayed with it and cleared it. Rich Peverly out to center with Tyler Seguin. End of his shift, he dumps the puck in. 3-2 Boston, 8.5 to go. Seabrook, the Michael Frolik, and he dumps the puck in. Rolling on the forecheck. Rare fourth line shift here for Chicago. Here comes Thornton. Kelly goes to the net. Sean Thornton tried to make a backhand pass. Malik tipped up as he tried to get to the puck. Paille around to Adam McQuaid. Into Sean Thornton. It got by Paille as well. For a leak to the puck against Kelly. Spins and passes to Boland. Marcus Kruger stops up, drops the puck off. Frolik forced to his backhand. Good back check by Sean Thornton. Kruger to the blue line. Oduya takes a shot. Scores! A break, finally a break for the Blackhawks. Oduya off Raskin in 3-3.
Couple of mistakes. Sean Thornton at the end of a fourth line shift over pursues. His point man is the guy who ends up getting the shot. He goes after the puck carrier instead of allowing the centerman. A little miscommunication, and watch Ferentz. Ferentz's left skate almost past the net ends up deflecting this one in. It goes by the goaltender. Ferentz isn't even looking, right off his skate and in the back of the net.
As a defenseman, you always have to be so aware of the angle of your skate and where it is around the front of the net because of that situation right there. Shot that was purposely shot wide so it couldn't be blocked, ends up in the back of your net.
Seems the only way you can beat Tuukka Rask is to get a break around the net, and Johnny Oduya did. And the Blackhawks have tracked down the Bruins and tied it up 3-3. And there's much life in the United Center again. Remember, Boston got this to 3-1. Boland scored a minute 51 after Bergeron. And now Oduya has tied it up. And now the Bruins have iced the puck again, and Milan Lucic is arguing that he got it.
And there's another instance where Lucic doesn't think it's icing. He goes in just to protect the body and try to maintain control of the puck. All kinds of activity going on, the noise, you can't hear it. And watch, he's clearly an opportunity to get in and touch it, but instead of touching it, he tries to protect himself from Hjalmarsson. And a heads-up play by number four to get in there with his stick.
And so Boston has to face off in their own zone with Jonathan Toews, Hossa and Saad on the ice. Krejci to take the draw. And he got it back to Seidenberg. Chara. Flip the pucks down the ice. This should be fairly clear to all of them. But it's another icing call.
It's amazing how the games take on different life. And one mistake from a rookie defenseman, Torrey Krug, has made this a game. And now, as Elliott was talking between periods, the big guy's got to play so many more minutes. Krug hasn't been back on the ice. Chara and Seidenberg are going to be taxed here down the last 7:19.
Sharp's going to take the draw against Krejci this time. Krejci's waved out. Lucic has been pretty good in these situations on his strong side, but he lost the draw to Patrick Sharp. Close of all. Kane to Sharp with Hanzus in front. Nathan Horton with a chance to get the puck out, and he does. Milan Lucic didn't get it deep. Looked like he fanned on it. Back come the Chicago Blackhawks. Sharp was held up just enough of the line so he couldn't get to the puck. He's after Seidenberg. Krejci there in support again. Got the puck off the boards. Bruins are quickly trying to change here. Johnny Oduya. He's tied it up for Chicago. In deep. Will this be icing? Yes, it is. And another icing call, this time against Chicago, so they're forced back into their own zone.
It's amazing, though, guys, the momentum in games. You think about the Frolik penalty on Chara. Bad news. Fourth line penalty. Goal. Makes it 3-1. Who's on the ice? to make it 3-3 for Leek.
And he got an assist along with Kruger on the goal by Johnny Oduya. Yager with Bergeron and Marchand working the boards in the Chicago end. A pinch, held the puck in. Yager with a shot and a deflection into the netting, out of play. Game one has turned into quite a game. Johnny Oduya's goal at 12-14 has tied game one of the Stanley Cup final at 3. All the gears have been grinding on the benches of Joel Quenneville and Claude Julien. That leads us to our Hockey Night close-up for Subway Restaurants and how the Blackhawks got this game tied up.
Okay, the coach decides to put the fourth line on the ice. Frolik takes a penalty. He's one of the best penalty killers for Chicago. Back of the net. It's over, right? 3-1. Insurmountable lead. No one gets three goals against Tuukka Rask. No one gets two goals against Tuukka Rask. So there's the second goal, and then here's the Frolik assist on what is now the game-tying goal. Coaching breaks in momentum.
In four games, Pittsburgh couldn't get a break like that at all. And the Blackhawks get a big one in game number one here to tie the game 3-3. Hard to imagine, isn't it? They've already scored more goals than Pittsburgh did in a series against Boston. Bickle off the wing, snaps a shot wide. Seafoot up against Yager, who fought the puck to center. Here's Brad Marchand, takes the shot, Crawford. Stops the play as he just absorbed the shot by Marchand, who knew he had to get it away because he was going to be caught.
Well, what a luxury having the speed of Duncan Keith as your partner. Seabrook trying to make a play offensively, gets trapped inside the blue line, but watch how quickly the gap is closed. Marchand knows it, not going to be able to make a play, and Crawford able to hold on to the rebound.
Marchand, too. Impossible shot to score in the Stanley Cup Finals from there. But I love the fact it was right away to spray the goaltender with a little bit of snow. Just add another exclamation point to my shift before I go off.
Since the first period, Chicago's outshot Boston 26-10. Sometimes teams, when they're playing with the lead, have trouble getting back on the attack. A redirected shot by Sagan got to the goaltender.
That's the one thing Chicago's done very well in the latter half of this period, Jim, is get pressure on the Boston defense. We've seen four or five times where McQuaid getting knocked down, Ferentz getting knocked down, Chara being in that position, and the Hawks' speed is starting to break through and put pressure on those D to make plays.
Another icing call against Boston, and the whistle had barely gone when Jonathan Toews, Brandon Saad, and Marian Hossa came over the boards for the faceoff. Rich Peverly got the drawback. Hawks go straight ahead, and Toews is battling, trying to get the puck back, and he does. Roosevelt takes a shot, deflected twice to the corner. Hossa at the point, hit back in, but Peverly did a nice job to cut off the pass and throw the puck out to center. Sagan couldn't get the bouncing puck, neither could Saad, but Toews feeds it ahead. Brandon Saad reels it in, pass for Hossa, and he just couldn't get his stick on it. Back to center. Milan Lucic, Tyler Sagan to the net. Crawford kicks the puck away to the open corner. And Jonathan Toews picks it up for Chicago, and he's quickly through the neutral zone. Slaps the puck in the corner and then goes up against Zdeno Chara. Off the boards, took a bounce to the middle of the ice, and Saad holds it in for Chicago. Rask will make a play here, realizing the Blackhawks have peeled off to change on the fly. Seidenberg to Chara. Ahead to Nathan Horton. Checked, and the puck's back in the neutral zone. Chalmerson. Duncan Keith. Didn't shoot it on net. Shot the puck around on the boards for Kane. He's taken out by Bergeron. Plays the puck back in another board battle coming. Keith couldn't get there in time. Horton cleared the puck. Nicholas Chalmerson to Duncan Keith. And back. Puck got away from Kane. This will be an icing call against Chicago. Lots of this in the third period, and with 4:05 to go in the third period, it's advantage Boston with a faceoff in the attacking zone.
Well, it was almost a one-goal game for the Blackhawks. If Marian Hossa had been a right-hander, he might have had an easier time. You can see he stops up instead of going right to the net, and the pass goes ever so quietly by.
Lost the handle, so he gets some new tape. Bergeron won the draw against Hanzus. Boychuk just held the puck in. Marchand to Jágr. This is Hjalmarsson in deep out against this line. The centering pass comes to Boychuk. Takes the shot of his tip. Caught with the save. Rebound. Bergeron couldn't bury it. Jaromír Jágr at the side of the net. Tried to feed it back in front and couldn't. Hanzus, in support of his defense, gave the puck away to Marchand. To Jágr, had his stick lifted. And the Blackhawks managed to get the puck out to center. They're changing as Ferentz tries to take advantage of that. Quickly back in, his backhand pass to Sean Thornton. Swatted the puck behind the net. Kelly couldn't get there. Boston's changing, so Bickel gets out. His rink-wide pass was tipped by Paille. Seidenberg up the boards. He's hit, knocked down, but he got the puck to center. Off the boards, Thornton to Paille, breaking in, hauled down, balls over the goaltender. Play stopped, nets off. Crawford's got the puck and no penalty on the play. Sean Thornton rink wide off the boards. Paille took the puck and he took it to the net. No penalty there. Murray Crawford lost an edge, and at the end of this sequence, you'll see why.
Well, this is a great sequence here where there are a number of chances to score. One there, there's a great save there, two, three right there. All of this was created because of a Hjalmarsson careless pass. Could have made a play, didn't, took an icing, and icing led to that play by the Boston Bruins.
Crawford's skate went right off the post, and he had to get it sharpened.
By fearless, he right to the net. That's where you're going to score from.
Think there could have been a penalty there?
No. 3 minutes to go in game one, Stanley Cup final. No. Talk to me in preseason. Yes.
Saad drives wide, takes a shot. Last looking for the rebound. How did Hossa not put that in? Then he took a shot that went off the side of the net wide from the blue line. Oduya. Into Brandon Saad to the net. Rask again can't stop play this time. Jonathan Toews. Hossa drifting around in front of the net. In off the blue line. Hjalmarsson missed it. Filling in for him was Toews to hold the puck in. Chara blocked Hossa from getting to the puck and he chips it out of his own zone. Shots are now 37-25 in favor of the Blackhawks. They've tied game one 3-3. Brent Seabrook up the middle. Ryan Bickel. It's in, caught from behind by Patrice Bergeron. Puck's poked loose. Boland tried to get it over the boards for Bickel. Jaromír Jágr in his own zone. Ferentz. Brad Marchand to Bergeron. Duncan Keith closed ice on him and made sure the puck got out through center. And Ferentz is back. Shaw. Hanzus, Bickel on the ice. Bickel's going to change now. And an offside call is whistled down here at the Blackhawks attacking blue line with a minute 43 to go in the third.
Well, that little adjustment on the handle for Marian Hossa didn't work. He gets another chance with Saad making an excellent play to the net. A second chance by Jonathan Toews, and you can see the bouncing puck. I'm not sure whether Hossa thought that Toews was putting the puck behind the net. He started to go. Instead, it was there for a split second. Hossa just a little bit late off the leg of Zdeno Chara. His stick got caught.
Foot was in the way. The size, whatever size feet he has, size 13 foot in the way.
A shoot in by Oduya went over the glass, so the play is stopped in the faceoff. Will come back outside into the neutral zone. Scotty Bowman in his 17th Stanley Cup as a consultant to his son Stan, the general manager of the Chicago Blackhawks. Scotty was the winning coach. The last time the Blackhawks were in an original six Stanley Cup final, and the last time the Bruins were in one, 73 and 78. No! Andrew Ferentz, that's blocked by Patrick Kane. Could have been dangerous around the net. Johnny Boychuk to an open wing. Paille bounces the puck in. Kelly races to it. A good stick there by Michael Hanzus coming back. Roosevelt trying to get out of his own zone. Needs a second chance. And that was over and back at the blue line. Touch to Bruin inside. Offside with 1:05 to go. And a great thrust to the Boston Bruins.
Can't be too happy with seeing their 3-1 lead deteriorate. Really had been a perfect road game for the Bruins for the most part, but credit the Hawks with not stopping. In this period, it's looked like Chicago's been on their toes and the Boston Bruins a little bit back on their heels.
On their toes again as Hossa dumps the puck in and Rask covers up. And all that happens here is the faceoff moves into Chicago's attacking zone.
Boston can't be happy about is that the two goals that Chicago scored to tie it, those are self-inflicted wounds. One is not managing the puck properly, a turnover by Krug, ends up in the back of your net, and the other one you actually put in the back of your own net.
And Krug hasn't had a shift since, so it puts more strain on the defense of the Bruins as well.
And this game may go a little longer than
little
three
longer
periods, and that becomes an important part of it. Krejci and Taves. Krejci got the puck back. And Seidenberg, I think, got off Hossa. Yep, faceoff's going to come outside.
One player who's really been a factor in this game. Marian Hossa, but saw it too. I think the fact that Joel Quenneville saw something and liked that mix, we got to credit him with making the change early, and this line's been effective.
Hjalmarsson shot the puck in off the draw. Seidenberg back, a hard hit by Marcus Krueger. He's back up for Leek, Krueger, and Bolin together. And Boston breaks up. Nathan Horton into the neutral zone. Chicago gets the puck back. Hjalmarsson, Frolik, Jonathan Toews has come on with it. Frolik hit, spins off it, threw the puck in behind the net. Bolin to the puck. Back to the point, just kept in by Duncan Keith. Seidenberg fights off Toews, gets the puck to the corner. Frolik got there first. He's checked, but Toews is there. Spinning is Ferentz to the blue line, not out, held in. Here's Dave Bolin, winds up and fires. Seidenberg to save. Hjalmarsson holds the puck in just wide of the net in the dying seconds of the third period. Seidenberg sends the puck the distance, and that'll do it. Game one of the Stanley Cup Final is tied 3-3 through three. A 3-1 Boston lead evaporated on goals by Bolin and Oduya. Ron and Don are coming up in our third intermission on Hockey Night in Canada from Chicago. Over 50%, and that line has really led them along.
Yeah, and I think the boys talking about the trust factor, I think Joel Quenneville is accustomed to shuffling his deck a little bit. The players respond well to it. I think more than anything, he just wanted to get a feel for how this game won, how much of a different stage it is in a Stanley Cup final, and his team took a while to get going. But that third period, they played much more like the Chicago Blackhawks of the regular season.
I just want to let Elliot know that I'm actually here doing the game two as well. I know he doesn't pay much attention. I've been on the panel with him. Hey, if I'm the Chicago Blackhawks, what I'm saying to my guys in the dressing room is we have more game breakers than them. We are more wired to have OT magic than the Boston Bruins, who may have more of a complete team game. But when the game's on the line, we have more guys like Toews, like Kane, like Hossa, like Saad, who can break a game open.
Well, we're about to find out if this will end quickly or will it be a marathon night. Playoff overtime goals, there are a few players who have been heroes. This season for Boston, it's been Bergeron with two, Marchand and Krejci, Kane, Seabrook, and Bickle have this season's overtime goals for the Chicago Blackhawks. The Stanley Cup Final, Game 1, overtime underway in Chicago. Zdeno Chara, the Dennis Seidenberg. The Toews line is on the ice, so is the Krejci line. Up the middle, Lucic tried to get the puck and couldn't. In comes Hossa, he shoots and he missed on the short side. Krejci hustles back, up the middle out of the reach of Horton. Nicholas Hjalmarsson threw the puck to an open wing. Nathan Horton plays it back as Boston regroups. Long pass for Krejci at center. And he has to regroup again under pressure. Chara, rink wide. Horton into the middle. Krejci for Chara, who is up on the play. And now Milan Lucic just filling in for Chara as Shaw goes right at him. Jonathan Toews for Shaw, and he knocked the puck just wide of the net. Ryan Bickle, checked by Bergeron, protected the puck, and then his pass went off a skate and comes all the way down the ice on the fresh ice. Dave Bolin leaves the puck there. Duncan Keith will start up. Long pass up the middle. Bounced to just about right to Shaw, but back the other way. Bergeron shot up high, and Crawford makes the save. There'll be a faceoff in the Chicago zone.
Well, an opportunity early for the Hawks as Zdeno Chara gets caught in, trying to pinch in, make something happen. That's number 17, Milan Lucic, back on defense, and that one just barely a little wide, and never a bad thing to shoot. As Bergeron, as you mentioned, the hero twice in overtime, tries to get one up high on Crawford.
Bergeron and Hanzus. Bergeron got the draw. Jágr got the puck. Taken away by Duncan Keith in an attempted pass, but they'll do it all over again because that's an icing call against Chicago.
Well, if you're looking for a spark, you think of Jaromír Jágr. He's mired in the longest slump of his National Hockey League career. 18 games, now going on 19 with four overtime goals. What a boost it would be if he could come get one now.
Bergeron won the draw cleanly. Boychuk shot and a nice save by Crawford. Johnny Boychuk has 5 goals in the playoffs, and the Bruin defense have 15, so they've been excellent, and a lot of it has to do with winning faceoffs.
Faceoff play. Bergeron moves Ferentz up to the top of the circle because he knows it's going to be a quick bang-bang pass for a one-timer.
Hanzus won the ensuing faceoff. Duncan Keith has the puck. He goes up the middle, but he was sure that Bolin would get it, and he did. Patrick Kane in on the defense. He's 1-on-3. Delays, puts the puck on net. Rebound, knocked down. A bouncing puck, though, and a swing and a miss. Quickly out to center. Here's Brad Marchand with some speed. Shoots, and he missed on the short side with Seabrook trying to get to him.
Seabrook was way over to his right. I think Keith thought he was underneath him. A long way to go.
Here's Patrick Sharp. His slap shot is stopped by Tuukka Rask. Letty holds the puck in, got away from Sharp. Krueger fed the puck in front and Sharp missed it. Adam McQuaid off the boards, not out. Hawks have the puck. Sharp tried to pass instead of shooting. Now he tries again to pass the puck to Kane, and the Bruins get it. Sagan's out to center. Peverly's with him into the middle. Here's Sagan to the net, just out of his reach and off the tip of his stick. Nick Letty turns and look at him go, back the other way. Great skater. Puts the puck in deep. After it is Marcus Krueger. Line mates are changing. He gave the puck away off the boards to Peverly. Sagan looking for Doggevins. Just put an aerial out to center. Roosevelt stepped up. Bunted the puck ahead. And here's Michael Frolik. Backhander goes wide of the net. Taves double shifting. Blackhawks hold the puck in. Taves can't come up with it. Kelly does. To Thornton. And he shoots the puck in. Kelly's on the fly against Seabrook. He made the play, and the Blackhawks get back out to center. Johnny Boychuk drives the puck back in. Thornton on the boards, awaiting its arrival against Seabrook, but Seabrook forced him out. Boychuk is back. First overtime, like the second period, long change for both teams. Boychuk, Torrey Krug back on the ice in overtime. And he put the puck off the boards and all the way down the ice. And now he's iced it, forcing the 5 Bruins to stay on the ice, and it's the fourth line, and they've been out there for a little bit.
And this is a tough play, too. Krug had a winger up high, just trying to put it off the boards. You be the judge here. This goes right through the feet of Duncan Keith. Not a lot of argument on the Bruin bench, though.
Off the draw, Bruins get possession. And Paille got it all the way down the ice, and Jalmerson's trying to be as slow as possible. And it's another icing call against Boston by the same group.
Is it windy in here or something?
Yeah.
Because this looked like
it was never going to get there, was it?
And Jalmerson, the way he skates back for the ice, I don't think he took a stride past the blue line.
He was at public skating.
Waiting for the hurry hard.
Taves had a quick rest and wasn't on for the last faceoff. He's back for this one with Saad and Hossa. Brandon Saad's going to come in and take the draw. Could be advantage Kelly, but Taves stepped in. A winger win, but out come the Bruins. Here's Paille. Backhander to Thornton. Hooked the puck in front. Now he backhands it in front, and he couldn't get the puck to Paille. And a wonderful opportunity for Boston's fourth line to be heroes after icing the puck twice. Back comes Brandon Saad for Chicago. Takes the shot. And then off a stick and over top of the net. In comes Hossa. First on the puck. Almost got away from him. Jonathan Toews cuts into the middle. Ran into a Bruin. And Seidenberg went down, but he stopped the play. Here they are again. Hossa to the front of the net. That's behind Brandon Saad. This line looks like best bet for Chicago to win it. Seidenberg. Krejci line is on the ice. Horton can't get the puck out. What a tough time with that tonight. Off the bench is Bickle. Chicago changing with the pressure on. Bickle trying to center, can't do it. Horton again, can't get it out. And a slap shot wide off the stick of Dave Bolin. Patrick Kane to Bolin with Bickle, who tips the puck in. And now he's going to go after Seidenberg. Bolin comes in looking for the loose puck. Marchand couldn't get it. Chalmerson to Kane. And back as the Blackhawks regroup. The pass up the middle. Bickle to Kane, coming up with speed on the right side. Can't get by Marchand with the puck. But the Hawks keep it in. A centering pass. Bolin can't get a good shot away. Spun around and couldn't get it with his backhander. And here comes Jaromir Jagr to Marchand at center. Jagr comes up late. Back to Marchand to the net. Missed on the short side. Boychuk hammers the puck. And Crawford made the save and deflected the puck off the glass and into the netting.
Well, some anxious moments. Thornton not known for his goal-scoring abilities, but he does an excellent job of following the play of Paille. Little backhand, no look. And he almost gets it through to the front of the net for Paille. And then Bolin finds himself alone. Nice pass by Kane, but can't get the handle.
Dave Bolin scored one of the two goals and the comeback for Chicago to tie this at 3-3. Cougar won the draw from Peverly. Blackhawks along the boards. Frolik got the puck down the ice, and there have been a lot of post plays, a lot of attempted icings, a lot of icings in the game. That one waved off as Frolik dumps the puck back in. And now another icing against Chicago.
Well, here's a real chance now. You've got the fourth line. You've got Leddy and Roosevelt. And guess who comes over the boards for the Boston Bruins?
Didn't waste any time to get the Krejci line out there. With Milan Lucic, Nathan Horton.
Watch a similar faceoff play with Ferentz to Boychuk.
Boychuk lined up to take the big shot. Krueger wins a big draw. Roosevelt puts the puck around on the glass. And if Frolik couldn't stop it, the puck will come all the way down.
Oh, boy.
Another icing call.
Any argument down there, Glenn, on that one?
No, this is a world record.
Yeah.
The icing's in a Stanley Cup final game.
A lot of play around the wall, but some of them, most of them are all legit.
Uh-oh. Krueger's waved out. Frolik has to come in and take the draw. This should be advantage Krejci. Wins it cleanly. Boychuk shoots into the crowd, and the puck deflected out of play, and there'll be another faceoff, but Chicago can change.
What a job getting out there and getting a body in front of that shot by Boychuk. Excellent execution off the draw. Look at how easily Krejci wins it. And a foot by Bolig, playing goaltender out at the hash marks, made a great play to keep that from getting to the net. Skate saving a beauty.
Now Jonathan Toews comes on with his line mates. Krejci line stays. Toews wins the draw. Marian Hossa hits Toews. Coming up with speed. Takes a shot. It's blocked. And the Bruins will try and go the other way with numbers. They're 3-on-2 to center. And a great stick by Nick Chalmerson in front of Nathan Horton. Another turnover at the blue line. Another turnover in the neutral zone. Here comes Jonathan Toews. Hossa to the net. And once again, they can't get the puck to the goal. And at both ends, that's been a recurring theme.
Each side was trying to get it back to the other, as you said. Turnovers in the neutral zone, opportunities squandered. And you know, come overtime, one turnover You can't afford to make that mistake. The Bruins do it. And the end result, frustration for Jonathan Toews not being able to get a shot through Chara.
Defensive zone faceoff, no Chara on the ice, end of a long shift for him. That's advantage Chicago if they can win the draw.
On Zeus, it is Bergeron, tried to win it on his forehand. It's a scrambled draw. Marchand came in and got the puck. Kelly was on as the second center. He goes to the bench as he dumps the puck in. And on comes Jaromir Jagr. Hanzus back in support of his defense. Up the boards. Pinching defenseman Boychuk held the puck in. Brent Seabrook for the Blackhawks. But Patrick Kane and out to center. Ferentz almost stripped of the puck by Patrick Schott. Jagr to Marchand. Taken away from him by Brent Seabrook. Bruins are changing. A stretch pass up the middle. Just out of the reach of Sharp. Goes in on Rask. And he stops play. And it took a while for the whistle to go.
Another snow to the face, as Glenn was mentioning earlier. Sharp just inches away off a nice stretch pass. And Rask, thinking about playing it, but seeing he didn't have any support, blocks the snow.
Stop the phone with the Guinness World Book of Records. 19 icings tonight. Next one will be the 20th. That has to be a record.
Bruins for the breakout. Chris Kelly at center. Up against Nick Leddy. He has Roosevelt on the other side. Chara holds the puck in for Boston. Centering pass for Sagan, and his feet look like he stepped on the puck and fell down. Pickle at center, turned the puck over. Kelly coming back in with Sagan. And Peverly. Sagan gets to the puck. Peverly turns, looking for the puck on his forehand. Can't get it. But Chicago can't get out. Back in comes Tyler Sagan. Drop pass. Peverly with a shot. Top of the center. Rebound. He stopped that. Two on Sagan. Another loose puck. And Dogovans couldn't find it. From the blue line, Krug holds the puck in just out of the reach of Kasper's Dogovans. Leddy up the boards, can't get out. Dogovans steals the puck, shoots, Crawford makes the save, and he stops play. Post call.
Great sequence around the net, some frantic moments. Peverly with the shot, the rebound there as Crawford looks for it at his feet. In comes Tyler Sagan, who's been frustrated himself, and an excellent desperation effort by Crawford.
It's been a quiet line for the Boston Bruins. Sagan had some of his best games in the last two against Pittsburgh. Really quiet tonight. That's his first shift where it looked like he could get something done for his team.
All through the playoffs, they haven't been able to put up numbers. Here comes Jonathan Toews. Weak shot on net. He wanted the rebound and got it, but it was just out of the reach of Hossa. Krejci takes the puck from Lucic. Horton's over on the other side. Krejci gets the puck in deep. Crawford's out to play it. Put the puck on the boards and gave it right back to the Bruins, but Hossa took it away, and out he comes to Brandon Saad. His drop pass to Johnny Oduya. Too late in getting there, but he got the puck in deep. Chara's back first. Horton made sure this time to get the puck out. Keith to Seabrook. On a change, he goes up the middle again, and the puck is tipped in. Oleg's in after it, and Tuukka Rask decides to hold on again.
Smart play by Rask there, too. Two of the forwards hadn't been able to change in Horton and Krejci. Once again, he realized long chains for both sides, and get the faceoff, allow Claude Julien to do his job.
You have the real luxury of having so many centers that he knows could come on and win the draw, so safer to stop the puck and stop the play. Hanzus against who else but Patrice Bergeron. Off a shin guard to Seabrook. Adam McQuaid. Up the boards. A good thing that was knocked down by Hanzus, because there was a player in behind him. Back in he comes. Patrick Sharp to the net. Wide of it. Bergeron chases the puck. Keith gets there first. Ferentz against Sharp, who stripped him of the puck. But Kelly got back. Another bounce off the referee, and that went the Bruins' way. Bergeron to Marchand. They've teamed up a couple of times. Bergeron stops up. The puck got away from him. Indeed, Duncan Keith taken away by Brad Marchand as Keith goes down. Hanzus came back to help out, and the Hawks have the puck. Grant Seabrook, Boston's changing. Hanzus to center, off the glass and in. Barron stripped to the puck by Patrick Kane. Bowling comes in after the loose puck. Throws it back hard to the point. Roosevelt did well just to hold the line. Marcus Cougar, checked by Ferris. The league follows, wants the puck. It comes loose to Johnny Boychuk. Up the middle to Dan Kaye. Can't control it after he stopped it. Neither can Michael Frolik, but he has some time and space. Gets the puck back and shoots it wide of the net. Roosevelt thought about pinching. Now he backs off defensively against Kaye. He'll dump the puck in. Letty's back. Under pressure from Tyler Seguin. Frolik. Rich Peverly at center. Seidenberg. Or Seguin. Got by him. No icing here. Roosevelt. Up against Krejci. In comes Bolin. Just out of the reach of Bickel, and he threw the puck along the boards. Chalmerson raced over, got to it, held the puck in for a second. Here come the Bruins, 3-on-2. Milan Lucic drives wide, passes in front, and Crawford blocked that before it got through to Krejci. Turning off the board, Horton, Tara, stopped by Crawford. The bouncing puck to the boards. Horton back to the blue line. Chara on the open side. Seidenberg takes the pass off the board. Feeds it in. Lucic. Cross ice intended for Krejci. Intercepted and cleared. The ebb and flow of overtime hockey. Good push by the Bruins. Trying to come in again. Johnny Oduya swept the puck away from Jaromir Jagr. Krejci still in deep. Here's Brandon Saad with some energy back to center. Spun off a check. Cross ice, and the other two forwards have to turn back. Taves and Hossa. Long pass for Saad. He tips the puck here. Rask plays it to the board. Bounce. Thrown wide of the net by Brandon Saad. Jonathan Taves is there. He ran into Ferris. Hossa protects the puck. Feeds Duncan Key. Brink wide. Fanning on the shot with Seabrook. Steal the puck again. Hossa, that'll slow it down. Johnny Boychuk got to him, but that's been hard to do tonight. Hossa's won a lot of battles along the boards. Too many men on the ice here. Wow. Chicago got caught in the midst of a change, and the puck was thrown up the boards, and the Boston Bruins are going to get an overtime power play.
Is that Karma, Glenn? A similar type of a play. Sharp jumps on and plays the puck. And look at that look with Coach Quenville.
And the shovelers are on. So your timing could not be worse. Overtime, at least a little bit better ice.
No question about the call, though. The guy comes on sharp. That's one you have to let go. You saw good chances. The energy, when you get an opportunity offensively, find some life in those legs. A little give and go. Lucic to the outside. Stumbling Jarmelson for a second. But look at the job of Oduya coming back. And after that, a one-timer for big Zdeno Chara gets blocked in front by Johnny Oduya.
Well, Boston has a big chance in the game here now, but this overtime has had lots of chances for both teams. This has been one of those nights where you've got 74 shots on net combined for both teams, but both teams had their moments when they could have ended. The fourth line here for Boston, that could have been lights out. 1-0. Boston could have home ice. Another scramble in front of the net. Everything but putting the puck in the back of the net, and the oldest guy on the ice. Watch the compete level of Jagr. He wants the puck more than Saad and does everything he can to make sure he gets another offensive chance because of it.
Well, how about these goaltenders? Both have been so dominant throughout the playoffs. Barely a difference in their goals against average. And for each of these teams to get three, it hasn't happened often. For Corey Crawford, he's been solid. Here's Tuukka Rask, accustomed to getting some shots on goal, that's for sure. And when he does, he typically wins.
One guy who'll get a shot on goal for sure on this power play is Krug. Give a chance for Char to rest, played a lot of minutes. This is a look they didn't have during the regular season or in the first part of the playoffs. One thing about him, he's very creative, and he gets his pucks through to the net.
This is interesting, though, with all that time while the shovelers were on, they still go with the number two power play. Blackhawks got the puck, couldn't get it out. Seidenberg and Krueger at the points. Marchand, Portman, Krejci up front. Seidenberg, Torrey Krug walks in, shoots, stopped by Crawford. Rebound cleared to the boards, Krug's got it again. Krejci, rink wide, Seidenberg, there's a screen in front as Krug gets the pass. Krejci thought about one-timer. Now he can't get the puck through as Marcus Krueger blocked that, and he's hurt. Krejci, Torrey Krug, Dennis Seidenberg spins off Frolik's check. Back to Torrey Krug, rink wide, Krejci, one-timer, stopped by Crawford, rebound, Horton off the post, bouncing puck in front of the net, still loose, it comes to Krug, Krejci couldn't one-time it, Bedlam in front of the net, Krejci gets a hold of the puck, goaltender doesn't have a stick, Torrey Krug slides down, Krejci, one-timer, up high, Horton's doubled over as he goes to the bench, Krug couldn't hold the puck in, Frolik's after it, Krejci got back first. Torrey Krug stays on, picked up the puck and he'll carry it in. Krug snaps a shot. That was blocked and now Krug's got to get off. Minute 15 gone in the power play.
And Horton's gone to the dressing room too. You see him barely get off the ice.
After he just about won it, put a shot off the post. Top power play unit is now on. Pretty good looking second unit. There's a pass up the middle. Sagan couldn't get it. Lucic rushes onto it. He can't get control from the blue line. Bergeron takes a shot. Easily kicked out by Corey Crawford. Jager for Lucic. Couldn't get it. Seabrook swatted at the puck. Moved it up the boards, but not out. Sagan overskated it. Seabrook gets another chance. He was checked by Lucic. Two-on-two battle in the corner, and the puck comes to Hossa, and he's able to clear it. And we're in the dying seconds of the penalty. Penalty's over. Three shots on the power play. Shots in overtime. 10-3 Boston. But it's still 3-3 as we play on in sudden death overtime in game one of the Stanley Cup Final. Jaromir Jagr out with Chris Kelly and Rich Peverly. Puck's bounced out to center. Patrick Sharp races to it. Gets the puck. Backhander tried to finesse it in and Tuukka Rask made the save. To center, Roosevelt, to Brandon Saad. Passes out of the reach of Brian Bickle. He's checked and Kelly gets the puck. Rink wide, Peverly touched it, moved it ahead. Here's Paille with a shot, just wide of the net. Brian Bickle is back, turns. Roosevelt had to turn back. Both teams making changes as Roosevelt plays the puck up the middle. Jonathan Toews on with Hossa and Brian Bickle right now. Toews gathers the puck in, checked by Ferentz. Bickle and Peverly come together. Ferentz plays the puck around. Seabrook reads that and holds it in. Marian Hossa turns off the board. Centering. Toews shot. Blocked by Peverly. And the ricochet goes to David Krejci. He sends the puck down the other way. Lucic is after Seabrook, who threw the puck up the middle. Chipped in by Hossa. Big hit by Shaw. He got Seidenberg, but the Bruins have the puck. Could be a two-on-one. Shaw's trying to get back. Off the wing, the pass in front. Crawford makes a wonderful save on Sagan. And the loose puck, the Bruins couldn't get to it. Krejci couldn't. Centering. That's Chara's shot blocked by Hossa. It hit him in the hand and hurt him. Duncan Keith, an outlet. Here's Dave Bolin with Andrew Shaw. Bolin trying to get to the net. Can't do it. Then he tipped up Seidenberg. Shaw gets the puck. Threw it in front. Bounced off a skate. Coming off the bench is Oduya. Passes off. Kane shoots. Rask makes the save and hangs on. Pretty good overtime action and chances at both ends.
Well, what once was a library is back to a concert hall. Great action end to end. Both goaltenders very sharp. Big hit by Shaw and Seidenberg, what they've been doing all night long. But back at the other end, what an opportunity. In all alone, Tyler Seguin with the shot, the rebound there for a split second. You could see Crawford couldn't find it in his pads, but watch the effort coming back as Krejci has the opportunity for the open net, and Bolin comes back and strips it away.
Bergeron waved out of the faceoff circle. Everly and Kruger faced off, and the Bruins have a chance to clear the puck, but Kane got to the puck first. Patrick Sharp. Out of the reach of Kane, couldn't get the puck in his feet. Oduya pinched down to keep the puck in. The referee's got it in his feet again. Kane with Sharp out front, plays the puck to the blue line. Chalmerson, a little give-and-go play. Kane takes over with some speed, snaps a shot, and Rask has got it. Picked it up through the crowd with Michael Hanzus whacking away and maybe trying to knock the puck loose.
Well, the game's most dynamic player was the hero that got this Chicago team to the Stanley Cup final. And Kane with another great chance to crowd, and Rask puts his arms up.
Watch the effort level of Sagan in the back of your the picture. Look at how hard he works to make that a 3-on-2 and to end the game. And one player who has gone off, and that's not good news for the Boston Bruins, is Horton. Nathan Horton gets hit there. They've won 7 straight playoff rounds with him in the lineup. He wasn't in the lineup when they played against the Washington Capitals last year.
That looked like his shoulder came out, didn't it? Just the reaction, the way it happened.
Or a stinger, but not good news.
Remember the fight he had with Jarrell McGinley late in the season? He went down hard on his shoulder and missed some time. Kelly gets the puck in. Duncan Keith gets it back out. Andrew Shaw. Bickle races after it. Had a look around to see who was with him. Ferentz got to the puck first. Kelly turned back into the crowd. Just about stripped of the puck by Bickle. Bounces towards the side of the net. Rask can't grab onto it. Ferentz just bulldogs Bickle onto the ice and onto the puck, and the play is stopped.
Well, a few anxious moments, though, as that puck was up in the air and two Bruins trying to get after it. You have the... You never know where that puck's going to go. Watch, it's in the air. Stick comes down, and the crowd behind the net for a second saw it on mesh and thought it might have got in. I think Tuukka Rask will take that face off any day.
On come Chara and Seidenberg for a defensive zone faceoff. Taves, Hossa, and Saad with Chalmerson and Oduya. Another win for the Bruins, but the Hawks get the puck back. Taves for Hossa. Got away from him. And thanks to the work of Seidenberg, Chara has the puck. His outlet. Kelly feeds Lucic. Got in deep, Krejci. Kelly in Horton's spot here. Seidenberg trying to hold the puck in. Oduya doesn't have a stick, so he makes a hand pass back to Chalmerson. He doesn't get it far around on the boards. Bruins have it back. Chara to the net, easily stopped by Chalmerson. And he eases the tension by clearing the puck. Seidenberg trying to take advantage of a change. Lucic into the middle. Oduya there to clear the puck to center. Michael Frolik. He's got Marcus Kruger with him. Shoots off the wing, and Rask makes the save. Frolik again. Centering, the puck goes off the glass to Seabrook. Turns and fires. Rask makes the save. Here's Frolik. Turns and fires again, and Rask made the save with Kruger screening. Peverly gets to the puck. To Chara. Lucic tips the puck out for the Bruins. Duncan Keith is back to his partner Brent Seabrook. Wink wide, Frolik again with some room, shoots, that's the save, and Frolik couldn't get to the rebound. Just a little slip by Seidenberg, almost got Frolik a goal. Good back check by Kruger, got the Hawks the puck back.
Hey, look at Tuukka Rask, he looks like it's an exhibition game out here. Just calm and cool, no overplayment, no nervousness in goal at all.
Seabrook to Hanzus, to Kane and Sharp. Patrick Kane comes in and gets the puck. Good shot. He takes the shot, missed on the short side. In comes Keith against Jágr. Jágr got the puck by him. Peverly with Marchand. Has a little button hook against Roosevelt. He's pushed to the ice, and Kane gets the puck just over the line. Roosevelt ongoing. Holden dumps it in the last minute of the first overtime period. Out of his own zone comes Ferentz. Boychuk up the middle. Chris Kelly onto the wing. Paye couldn't get it because it was deflected up high. And Brian Bickle does. Rink wide, but still in his own end. Roosevelt under pressure to center. Shaw, Boland, and in deep. McQuaid is back. Down on the boards. Oduya trying to hold the puck in. Kelly gets it up to center. Here's a chance for a two-on-one. Sean Thornton off the wing. Shoots, top of the save. Rebound. Paye gets to it. He can't do much with it. Shaw got back and got the puck out of his own zone. Zdeno Chara on the other side for Paye. Oh, that looked close to offside. Turnover, and back comes Jonathan Toews. In on Seidenberg with some speed. Tried to cut to the net. Seidenberg got a stick on the puck. Thornton deep in his own zone. And the horn sounds to end the first overtime period. Still 3-3. Game one of the Stanley Cup Final. Still undecided.
Well, no lack of action at all in this overtime. Frolik, just a quick turnaround through traffic. And look at Tuukka Rask. Find that through Kruger in front. And then on the outside, Frolik again trying to end this game. Rask calmly gets it away.
47 shots for the Chicago Blackhawks. This would have been 48 late if it wasn't for a great stick by Seidenberg.
Shots in that first overtime were 12-8 in favor of Boston. No scoring, obviously. So it's 47-37 Chicago overall in shots on goal. Ron and Don, the studio crew, all coming up in the next intermission on Hockey Night in Canada.
Nobody won't get what they want tonight, a victory in game one of the Stanley Cup Final. Glenn Healy was unhappy about my throw last intermission, so let's mention that Glenn is calling this game with Jim Hewson and Craig Simpson. Gentlemen?
But if you try sometime, you just might find you get what you need. And we'll see if that comes true for these teams in the second overtime period. How disruptive will it be without Nathan Horton for a team like Boston that seldom ever alters its lines?
I think it's a wonderful opportunity for a guy that desperately needs a breakout, and that's Tyler Seguin. And I think if I'm Claude Julien, as he's doing here to start, you put him right in this spot where Nathan Horton could be, and Seguin's going to get his chance here in overtime to be the hero.
Let's bring in Scott very quickly.
All right, Jim. Well, Nathan Horton looked like he was favoring his left shoulder or his arm when he left the ice and went to the Boston Bruins, where he obviously remains. It's the Bruins' policy to not say anything about injured players, but he's not come back to start the second overtime, so the assumption is that he will not be back the rest of the night.
And it looked pretty innocent, but you could tell it that hurt, and he didn't stop. He went straight to the dressing room, and his line is on to start the second overtime period, and Tyler Seguin is out there with David Krejci and Milan Lucic against the best Chicago line tonight. Jonathan Toews, Brandon Saad, Marian Hossat. Second overtime of the first game of the Stanley Cup Final underway. Chalmerson back off the boards. And here's Toews starting up to center. His pass is way behind Brandon Saad. Stepping up is Seidenberg. Seguin has Lucic out front as he goes after the puck against Oduya, who knocked it away. Johnny Oduya got the last goal of the game. Saad with a relay the Toews didn't get through. Seidenberg back the other way. Didn't quite get to David Krejci. Back in comes Jonathan Toews into the middle off escape. Krejci takes off. Oh, no. Big collision by the Bruins, and Krejci's on his own. It was Lucic and Yager ran into each other, and they're just now getting back up. Here's Ferentz. Throws the puck to the front of the net. Came off the goaltender and quickly moved out by Brian Bickle. Marian Hossa stopped up and took a shot that was blocked, and now he wants to hustle back and get to the bench. Yager shaken up but stays on after the collision with Lucic, who was at the end of his shift. And the play is stopped here, and the faceoff's coming way back into the Boston zone.
I can just imagine what these two guys are saying. Are you kidding me? This is an odd man rush, which potentially could have been a 3-on-1. And that happens? Timing could not be worse.
And then Lucic gets hit again just to add insult to injury.
And Seabrook had fallen down too, so the defenseman was caught. Comedy of errors there.
Krejci must have wondered what was going on. He thought he had 3-on-1, and then he's almost on his own. Here's Johnny Boychuk pinching for Boston. Couldn't get the puck. Now he's trying to get back defensively. Paye was filling in for him. Andrew Ferentz up the middle. Boychuk for Kelly. He dumps it in. Kelly, Paye, and Peverly together. Duncan Keith, throws the ball out of his own zone to Michael Hanzus at center. With Kane and Sharp. Beverly on the back check. Trying to get some help from Kelly, taken away by Patrick Kane. The puck goes to Jalmerson, and right on him was Paye, forcing the puck out into the neutral zone. Will somebody get tired? Make a mistake? There have been four double overtime games, two in succession, the last two overtime games in the playoffs. Bickle threw the puck out front. And over and back at the blue line, that's offside.
Well, there's certain hits that hurt a whole lot more, and a lot of times when you hit your own man, you're not expecting it. And for Jágr, that is a big body going head-to-head. And there's Krejci, like you're saying. He's thinking he's got bodies. Look at everyone on the ground. Lucic catching his breath afterwards. I'm sure they'll have a little laugh if they can pull off a victory here.
Here's a pass up the middle. Tyler Seguin breaking in. Stopped by Crawford. Another chance for Seguin, who can't buy one. Back the other way. Boland, long shot on Rask. Cooley knocked it down and played the puck up the boards for Milan Lucic. With Krejci and Seguin into the middle. Seabrook is there. Sends the puck back the other way. Boland to Bickle for Shaw. The puck got away from him, and back come the Bruins. Lucic to center. It was partially blocked as it came through the middle, and Bergeron had to fight to get the puck back. Short shifts now. Double overtime. Bergeron forechecking. The pass comes up the middle. Here's Michael Crowley. Can't get by Andrew Ferentz. Threw the puck in the corner. It's skipped. Comes to the other side for Kruger. Back into Brandon Bolick. Krolik is there as well. Hard on the puck, threw it in front, might have gone off the skate, but it bounced the Bruins' way, and Bergeron cleared it.
What a heads-up play by Bergeron to realize his skates were in dangerous place. Didn't overreact, it hit him, and he cleared it away.
Here comes Brandon Saad with a shot just wide of the net. Taves along the boards. In a battle there, three Chicago Blackhawks hold the puck in. Here's Taves trying to go to the net from behind it. The wraparound, and Rask has got it. No garbage in front, no accidents. He stops playing.
Well, the 219's very active here. Tyler Seguin, frustrated with himself, did a nice job of reading that faceoff win up the middle with a rolling puck that he wasn't able to control. Oduya did a nice job coming back. And watch Bergeron here. Doesn't overplay. This is an opportunity. Might have gone in, just able to calmly get his skate up and clear the front of the net. Nice play.
Next year with the smaller nets, guys, those wraparounds will be a lot easier than they are tonight.
Sharp winger came in and won the draw. Roosevelt. Here's Hanzus. Out of the corner, Sharp played the puck off the boards and out of the reach of Nick Leddy, who has to back up.
Sharp was trying to hit it off the pad of Rask. Rask just got back in his net and didn't allow it anything to hit.
Patrick Kane straight up the middle on Chara, and Seidenberg shoots wide of the net. Chris Kelly's back to the puck. He gave it away and got it back. Seidenberg under pressure from Kane and Sharp. Up the boards, and Beverly gets out to center. Kelly with the shoot-in. Another quick change for both teams. Chalmerson to Johnny Oduya.
No!
Shoot-in. That's the linesman making sure they know there's no icing. Marian Hossa. Krejci got the puck away from him up the boards, and he gets a break and a bounce. Plays the puck to Lucic. Chalmerson was close to him, so he dumped the puck in. Now Chalmerson starts the breakout as the Bruins back off into the neutral zone. The pass into the feet of Hossa. Somehow he got it to his stick. Brandon Saad centering. And all tied up, literally all tied up in front, is Jonathan Taves, and he had no chance to get a hold of the puck.
You almost feel like Taves just needs a break too, doesn't he? To break out of his slump.
Yeah, both 19 stuck at one goal.
Hard to believe.
Johnny Boychuk is back. Up the boards, that took a Chicago bounce. Boland is there, holds the puck, and he's got Shaw and Bickle with him. Ryan Bickle, Marchand coming to check him. And he got some help from Patrice Bergeron, who cleared the puck. 5.5 minutes into double OT. Game one of the Stanley Cup Final. Duncan Keith to Bickle, that's waved off. Rask to Chris Kelly, defers to Marchand. Lost the puck to Patrick Kane. He has Bolin in front. The centering pass went off the skates of Chara. Marchand gets the puck to Jágr and into the middle to Chris Kelly. And he makes sure that he gets it deep. In fact, it's over the glass into the netting out of play.
3 hours and 40 minutes ago, we started this journey, and there wasn't much hate between these two teams. Well, 3 hours and 29 minutes into this match, this is what happened. Everybody taking a shot at Marchand. So yeah, it is game on. And not only is it game on, it is another day on the calendar in the East as the clock turns to 11 o'clock Chicago time, 12 o'clock out East.
They may institute those shallow nets before this one's over, Heels.
Or bigger, one or the other.
Yeah.
I vote for bigger.
Patrick Kane quickly out of his own zone. Got Shaw and Sharp with him, driving wide, shoots him out against the fourth line. Thornton tried to check him. The puck comes out front. Roosevelt to Leddy. They got in each other's way. The pass comes to Patrick Kane. Screen set up in front. Leddy to his backhand. Dangerous play to Roosevelt, who kept it in with two Bruins around. Seidenberg to Krug. There's a referee who went down hard. Kane to the blue line, Roosevelt. Nick Leddy into the middle. Kane's quick shot, didn't get much on it. Sharp is checked by Seidenberg. Thornton battles along the boards with Michael Hanzus. Sharp gets the puck to Leddy. Tough shift for the Bruins. Good shift for the Hawks. Hanzus centering. Kane can't tuck it in. What a great chance to win it for Patrick Kane at the end of a wonderful shift, and now he stays on. The Bruins trapped in their own zone, finally get to center. Thornton makes sure not to ice the puck. He only advanced it a little ways, and back in come the Hawks. But Bolick had to turn back to get the puck, and they couldn't catch the Bruins on an overtime change.
Jim, that was exhaustion by Kane. You just zap all your energy. You try so hard to focus. He just didn't have anything left in the tank to try to carry that across the side of the net.
Here's Tyler Seguin out with Lucic and Krejci. Seguin shoots. Crawford makes the save. Had to look for it, but he found it. And we'll go back to the other end to have a look at the great chance for Patrick Kane to win this game.
Well, I was a part of that triple overtime game one in the Stanley Cup Finals, and I'll tell you, you get bursts of energy when you think you got an opportunity to end the game. This is the end of that long shift. He's got it for a second, and you can see his body is just spent afterwards. He thought for a split second he could end the game. Instead, he goes to the bench frustrated and exhausted.
And can't move his legs. Krejci and Taves to face off. Another scramble draw, Krejci into the corner after the puck. Lucic to the blue line, but the Bruins were changing, and Chara was way out at center. Ferentz shoots the puck back in. Double overtime, and Coach Julian sticks with his match. He wants Chara on the ice when that Taves line is out there.
Good example of exhaustion there with Krejci. It's a delayed offside. He tries to make it across the line, but doesn't take the one extra stride that he needs to put it onside. Referee blows it down immediately.
Krejci won the draw. Boychuk's back for the puck. Chara rink wide. Seguin can't handle the puck off the boards. Backing up is Oduya, and that just came out over the line, or Krejci might have been in with Seguin towards the net.
Well, I can tell you, it's amazing what your mind goes through, and you try to just fight the fatigue in your body. And I know about this time, in second overtime, you think this game's never going to end. And you look, you be careful to not make mistakes. But each time you sit back there on the bench, you just try to regroup and re-energize yourself for that next shift.
Over 35 minutes of ice for Chara. Duncan Keith, 37. Chara had 41 shifts after the first OT. He's got now.
Here's Brandon Saad quickly out. This has been a long shift for these guys, and Saad lost control of the puck. Boychuk came right to him. Lucic comes back for the puck. Throws it around to Krejci. He'll tip it out to center, and Boston wants a change. Chicago wants the same thing. Sometimes late in these overtime games, the chances are few and far between because the shifts are so short, nobody's got any energy to go for it. And there's an offside call as Shaw and Bickle ran into each other.
Well, game one tells us a few things about this series is, who does Claude Julien want his best defenseman up against? You can see in round one, it was Kessel. Round two, Nash. Round three, the majority against Malkin. And then you could see Jonathan Toews head-to-head against number 33 here in game one.
Here's Dave Bolin gathering the puck in. A little drop pass. Bickle with a shot. Might have gone off Tory Krug, who is back there. And the Bruins get the puck and break out. Bergeron leading a 3-on-2. Marchand off the wing. Shoots. Crawford makes the save. And I was thinking for a second there that Marchand would be trying to get the puck to Bergeron for a deflection like he did against Pittsburgh in double overtime.
Well, with bodies in front, as we've already seen, the game-tying goal for the Blackhawks went off of Ferentz. Here's another one there that Rask can't get his glove on. And fortunately for the Bruins, it hits the hand of Krug and goes the other way. And then here's that little burst of energy. And this is a shot that if you could have back again, get it low at the pads and try to get a rebound, not high where you can get a face-off.
Kelly and Kruger. Chris Kelly won the draw too cleanly for the linesman. So they stopped the play. Kruger and Kelly again. Not so cleanly this time. Chicago gets the draw. Duncan Keith gets out to center. Try to pass to the right wing for Frolik. It didn't get through. Andrew Ferentz bobbled the puck, got to center. Paille relays it in. Seabrook sends it right back up. Frolik. Marcus Kruger goes to the net. Coming up late, Brandon Bolin. The pass back to the blue line. Roosevelt holds the puck in, and it deflected again out of play. Almost halfway through overtime period number two.
Not as much energy on the bench or talk as there was in the first couple periods, Glenn.
No, the guys are tired. Both benches. You think about the Boston bench minus Horton. Didn't play Krug a whole lot.
Good scheduling with 2 days off after game one.
Ironically, there was 2 days off back in 1990 as well.
Sharp and Krejci. Pucks up for grabs. Knocked down. There's a shot by Hanzus, and it was blocked before it got through. Lucic to Krejci. Tipped out. Oduya and Hjalmarsson. Turnover in the neutral zone. Krejci regroups. Once again with Sagan and Lucic. Long pass for Lucic. On his off wing, dumps the puck in. Johnny Oduya's back. Hjalmarsson up the boards. Ferentz pinches. Holds the puck in. Sagan can't help him out. He races to get back and dives to knock the puck away from Patrick Kane. Missed pass up the middle. And an icing call in double OT against Boston.
Well, they get a break here. Because there are no commercials, they do get a break because the shovels come out. Jonathan Toews is trying to argue, but that is the agreed upon rule. Crowd doesn't like it either, but it's the right call.
Let's take a look at why we're here till all hours of the night. Started right off the bat with a Lucic goal. 1-0 Boston in the first period. 2-0 Boston. Almost the same play, same goal. Saad, great shot here, top part of the net, and Rask has no chance. And then on a penalty by Frolik, Bergeron makes it 3-1. And everyone thinks it's over, but don't go away yet. You got to manage the puck against the Chicago Blackhawks. Open up the door a little bit, and they'll shut it on the 3-2. And then the last one was something that the Pittsburgh Penguins had no luck in, which was some good luck. A shot off the skate of Ferentz, 3-3. And it's been a wild night. Shots are 52-41 for the Chicago Blackhawks. Both goalies have been tested, and this could have been over a long time ago.
We mentioned there's 2 days off between games one and two, and these players will need it. Game two is coming up at 7 Eastern time. And at 7 Eastern, it'll be the National Hockey League Awards. We'll be on the air, let you know, in this shortened season with no big Vegas show coming up. National Hockey League Awards, and then shortly after 8 Eastern time, the face-off for game number two of the Stanley Cup Final from the United Center in Chicago.
Again, this crowd trying to bring some life and energy, understanding the importance of a face-off, offensive zone, an opportunity to end this game.
The alarm clock went off.
Now you look at the statistics, as Ron McLean mentioned, for teams that win game one, high 70s. The next goal is critical.
Another face-off between Jonathan Toews and David Krejci. Krejci won it. Wojciech up the boards to center. Sagan on the forecheck against Brent Seabrook. A rolling puck. He just gets it safely back out of his own zone. Ferentz with a rolling puck. Now Duncan Keith settles it down. Toews, Hossa, and Sutton. Bergeron's come on here with Marchand and Jágr. Puck shot wide of the net. Ferentz. Out for Marchand. He can't get to it. And this will go the distance, and Marchand knew that, so he just stopped to conserve energy at center ice and heads back into his own zone again.
Look how quickly this game can change with one break, and that's another one. We've seen so many icings that were close calls. That one was as well, went right by the Chicago defense.
Offensive zone faceoff, Keith stays out. See if he can muster a little double OT magic.
With Roosevelt poised to pass it to him, Hanzus can win the draw, and he can't, because it was Bergeron who was on the ice for Boston. Jágr helping out in the corner to Patrice Bergeron. Andrew Ferentz against Patrick Kane to center. Too many Hawks there. In comes Michael Hanzus. Kane drives the net. Hanzus drives wide. He's checked by Ferentz. Kane's checked by Wojciech. Chris Rooney wants them to play the puck, and they do. Ferentz will start out. Jágr can't knock the puck out of the air. Roosevelt is back. Moving up, Marchand, poke check by Roosevelt. Jágr comes over and gets the puck. His centering pass. Marchand can't quite get it. Hanzus did.
Look at the fatigue there. All three Hawks.
Nobody can move.
Nobody can move. Everyone's skating in sand.
Dave Bolin sent the puck around on the glass, and it took a favorable bounce, and that's waved off. It's pretty clear at the start that was going to be icing. Instead, it's waved off. The Bruins, Rich Peverly. In with Chris Kelly. Loose puck. Kelly gets to it. Peverly backhanders. And a nice catch off the stick of Hjalmarsson by Corey Crawford.
Boy, a great individual effort. Almost ended up in the back of the net instead at the other end. But here's the foot race. Pickle gets in. Does he get it? He doesn't, actually. Chara's stick hit it first, but the call wasn't there. Look at the big stick of Chara's actually gets it. But at the other end, it almost cost them. The Blackhawks forced to defend. Kelly fights off his man, and an excellent hand eye by Crawford to find that deflected shot.
One thing's pretty clear, the boards hurt. And you watch the last little sequence with Sharp and Wojciech. Pretty significant hit. Wojciech still on the bench though.
Krejci actually won the draw, but Hossa jumped up, got the puck to Brandon Saad. To the net, he wanted that rebound for Hossa. It was kicked into the corner by Rask. Saad. Cycle for Toews. Hossa, centering pass, hit the back of the net. Saad comes over and gets the puck. He's trying to get it out front. Hossa over to help out to the blue line. Hjalmarsson fakes the shot, takes the shot off the stick and wide. Brandon Saad calmly. Krejci steps in. Oduya kept the puck in. Toews against Chara. To the blue line again. Hjalmarsson kept it in. Brandon Saad. Marian Hossa. Toews works in front with Seidenberg, and the puck comes to the net. Steered aside by Rask. Oduya. Seidenberg steps in front of Jonathan Toews. And now the puck comes to Sagan, and he makes sure, and everybody badly needs a change now. Both sides. Hjalmarsson drops the puck off and heads to the bench. Duncan Keith, his partner Seabrook, just came onto the ice. Bounces the puck to center. Frolik for Kruger, and he'll dump the puck in. Brandon Bolin. Corey Krug can't get the puck out. Thrown back at the net just wide. Jaromir Jágr up against Duncan Keith. Advances the puck. Bergeron can't get to it. Jágr again. Into the attacking zone. Three Hawks there, and they knock the puck loose. Kruger can't get by Johnny Wojciech. A bouncing puck. And a snapper just wide from Frolik as he had a burst of energy and got to the puck. And that brought the fans to their feet. for only a second. Here's Brad Marchand in on the defense. Can't get a shot, can't get by Duncan Keith. Scooped out to center. Terrence fires it back in for Boston. Rich Peverly stopped it, threw it at the net, steered aside by Crawford. Kelly can't get to the puck, he ran into the goaltender and fell down. Hanzus. Back to Keith on the other side to Seabrook. Peverly comes after him to the blue line. Ferentz holds it in with a shot. Crawford steers it aside. Keith up the boards. Pinching was McQuaid, held the puck in for Peverly, trying to feed the front of the net. Patrick Sharp is there to Patrick Kane. Caught from behind by David Krejci. Here's Sharp trying to get open. Ferentz comes straight at him, stays with him. Kane comes in after the puck and gets it on his backhand. Trying to protect the puck. Feeds it back to the blue line. Roosevelt slap pass. Boland after the puck against McQuaid. He's checked hard and Ferentz gets a hold of the puck. And the Bruins start out again. David Krejci. Straight up the middle. Passes off. Paille to the net. Big rebound. Krug with a shot. What a save by Crawford on Tori Krug. That's one of the best chances in this second overtime period. Dennis Seidenberg turns, finds some energy to get to center, passes off on the wing, and Lucic bobbled the puck in his feet, and so the play went offside.
A couple of great chances, one for each side. He said the crowd got on its feet. I'm sure Kelly Rudy did as well. His guy Frolik, a bouncing puck, chips it over, and a quick shot just barely misses up and over, and Krug walks into this one. A rebound there for a split second and great response by Crawford.
Good example of Krug being the most dangerous player at both ends of the ice. And there's the hit we talked about with Boychuk and Sharp.
Boychuk dumped the puck in and it bounced to Corey Crawford, so he stops it, and the next faceoff is in the attacking zone for Boston. So they'll make a change. Marchand and Jágr are going to come back on and join Patrice Bergeron. All night long, it's been Jonathan Toews against Krejci, and now it's Bergeron's line. Toews with the draw. Chalmerson got the puck to center. It's bouncing. Chara can't get it out over the line. Marchand can't get it out over the line. Here's Hossa. Sod's in front of the net. The backhander knocked down by Tuukka Rask. And Marchand this time makes sure he gets the puck out. Oduya. Hip to the puck, Jágr's after it. Crawford calmly plays that puck into the corner. Seeing his mates on a change, Toews drops the puck off. And heads for the bench himself. With speed to center. Here's Krueger. In deep, Andrew Shaw checked by Tori Krug. Up the boards, Brent Seabrook holds the puck in. Just about lost it. Krejci can't clear it. Held in by the Blackhawks. Andrew Shaw held it in. Pickle along the boards to Shaw, trying to walk out, jam the puck, and it's behind the net. Nobody knew it. And the Bruins come up with a puck. Tyler Seguin. Two on two with Milan Lucic. Dumps the puck in on Duncan Keith. Lucic got there first. Seguin arrives second, and the puck has disappeared, and play is stopped.
Puck out of play to Rask. All kinds of bodies. His nice play from behind the net. Shaw takes it hard. Bodies flying everywhere as Seidenberg knocks him right into his goaltender. But right now, goalies are really finding the puck through traffic.
This is now officially the longest game of the 2013 playoffs.
Ferentz is upset. He was speared as he made his way into the offensive zone by Shaw. 100 shots tonight in the game so far, and that's not really one of them.
55 against Rask, a career high. Peverly got the draw, but the puck is pushed out by Patrick Sharp, who's after it. Hanzus there, Paille took it away, and Sharp in turn took it away from him. Ferentz, Adam McQuaid couldn't get the puck up. Chris Kelly comes back for it. An aerial that bounces down into the Chicago zone. Boston's playing with 10 forwards right now, with Thornton out. And Thornton, for the most part, stapled to the bench as Bolick moves back in, takes a shot. Rask scoops it up and stops play.
Well, there hasn't been much of this in the double overtime. We saw this through the whole game. Any exchange by the bed. See on the left side of your screen, there's the spear. Down goes Ferentz. He thinks the linesman should call it, or the referee. They're both there. No way you're going to get a call now. Not a chance. But that has now been limited, guys. None of that between the two benches. That's the first time in this overtime I've seen it.
Nobody's getting the energy for extracurricular activities. Marchand trying to dislodge the puck. Seabrook stayed with it. Marcus Kruger with Michael Frolik headed to the front of the net. Kruger takes the puck to the net, and he's stripped of it. Torrey Krug back the other way. Seabrook has to back off. Duncan Keith on his backhand dumps the puck in. Krug is back. Frolik's right on. Krug made the play. Took a hit. Seidenberg to Jágr against Taves. He got out. There's a 3-on-2. Krejci. Lucic on the other side. A great stick by Tomlinson to knock the puck away from him. And Jonathan Taves has a rush. In on the defense. Stops up. Takes a shot. Chara blocked that. Lucic off the glass and out. Sagan will rush after it. He tripped as he tried to get inside on Tomlinson. Johnny Oduya back the other way. Hossa dumps the puck in. Chara from Johnny Boychuk. Lucic. Nice little pass to Kelly at center. He's checked and knocked down by Hossa. Back in comes Dave Bolin. Slashed at by Sagan. Bolin on his backhand. Chara. He's checked by Shaw. In comes Bickle. Chara pins the puck to the boards. It comes loose. Bolin couldn't center it. And then the puck is taken away. And it's Kasper's Dogovins who gets to center. And no further. Following him is Sagan, who dumps the puck in. And Boston wants another change. Nick Leddy, latest Blackhawk to rush the puck over the blue line, dumps it in deep off the back of the net. Seidenberg just gets there and puts the puck around. No icing on this play. Long pass. Hanzus sharp to the net. Hanzus' shot ends up in the corner from a sharp angle, sends the Blackhawks back out into the neutral zone. Patrick Kane to Duncan Keith, who jumps up. He's got sharp rhythm, takes the shot. Big rebound, kick to the boards. Paye gets it out. Here comes Jaromir Jágr. There's a change, and it's a 2-on-1. The centering pass didn't get through.
Too many men for Chicago again.
Another one. Here's Adam McQuaid. Reels the puck in against Saad. Passes off. It hit a stick. And with 53 seconds left in the second overtime period, another too many men on the ice. Penalty against Chicago, and I guess that's why it ended up as a 2-on-1.
Yeah, of all the guys, too, it's Jonathan Taves. I'm not sure exactly what he was reading. Oh, he didn't change, or the centerman didn't change. Taves jumped on, then realized and went, whoops, can't come back. And that's just a big mistake, as Hanzus looked like he was going to change, did a little fake force. Taves didn't follow him to the bench and jumped on and got involved in the play.
It's actually David Boland that was the one yelling from the Chicago bench for Taves to come back and change. Taves didn't hear him until it was too late.
Mistake born of fatigue.
Yep. Boston taking a timeout to really focus and re-energize here, as you know, this might be their only opportunity.
Well, as the game wears on, one thing that you find that dissipates, it's the big physical play and the hitting. And here's an example. Kelly gets the puck. But it's actually a big hit by Hossa. Kelly's really got nothing he can do with the puck. He gets it, put on his keister. You got 52 seconds on bad ice. You're gonna have, if you don't score there, you got 1:08 with a fresh sheet of ice.
This is the third Boston power play, the second of overtime. 1-for-2 with a man advantage. They got a goal from Patrice Bergeron way, way back in the third period. Jaromir Jágr is on, Bergeron, Lucic, Tyler Sagan, Sedano Chara, four forwards, and Bergeron wins the draw. Chara handled up the big shot. Sagan off the board, protects the puck and spins. There's Chara on the other side. Jágr shoots a big rebound off. Crawford is cleared by Michael Frolik, and he and Kruger hustle to the bench and change the penalty killers. Can't waste too much time getting back to get the puck, because the period will be over pretty soon. Chara to center. Bergeron shoots the puck in around on the boards. Lucic let it go. Sagan gave it back to him in the corner. Jágr's there as well. Bruins get possession. Chara at the blue line. Bergeron's on the other side. Chara goes back the other way. Sagan to Chara. Quick shot off the post. Lucic can't bury it. Lucic again. Bergeron stopped by Crawford, who doesn't have a stick. Chopped to the blue line. Time's running out. Chara. Lucic better be quick. Can't get the shot off. And double overtime will turn into triple overtime thanks to a swollen goalpost behind Corey Crawford.
Well, fatigue, laughter, energy just being zapped after trying so hard to finish this game off. And you mentioned puck luck before for the Penguins. There was none of it. Here you've got two great chances, a rebound pass, Lucic and gone. And then another chance, the goalpost. Chara had to hurry that shot as it handcuffed him a bit, but right off the post, and then the opportunity for Lucic on the rebound, and he just couldn't quite handle it and get it back towards the wide open net.
Crowd's getting what they want. It's a 2-for-1 sale tonight. Your tickets are half price. Get games, to watch two.
Two games for the price of one. Oh, the Bruins thought they had it.
You don't think this Jaromír Jágr, forget about age, he wants one last chance. Talking to himself and laughing at himself.
Ron and Don and the studio crew coming up again. It's another intermission, triple overtime coming up on Hockey Night in Canada.
Well, you know, of all the stars in this game, I still think Hossa looks the most dangerous. He had a couple of good chances in that. You know, some guys like Saad and Kruger have been really good. Frolik's been really good, but there's just that power, PJ, you always talk about with Hossa that really stands out to me. He's had some good chances, but maybe it was that defensive play he made on the back check here on Kelly, not Kelly off the puck. I mean, that was a dominating play.
He still looks like one of the top players that can end this in one shot. That is still very explosive. I find a lot of the other guys slowing down that one step, of course, we're into the next day with the fatigue factor.
Yeah. Well, maybe it is the in-between intermission diet. What are they eating down there, Scuttle?
Elliot, when a game goes as long as this, nutrition is critical, so who's to say that this will not be the key to victory tonight? Pizza. Visiting teams usually bring in lots of pizza late in the third period for post-game, so there's still lots of that left in the Bruins room. And then for the following overtime intermissions, two of them to this point, they go with oranges and peanut butter and jam sandwiches. Lots of that available in the Bruins room. So enough sugar and enough carbs in all of that to help keep the energy level up. As far as hydration goes, most players mix their own drinks with their own tablets, their own powders. So that's taken care of as well. With respect to the Chicago Blackhawks, because they're in their own building, they have the advantage of bringing in whatever food they want. But both teams have hydration and nutrition well covered as this game goes on and on. Jim.
Do they do room service? A power play to start period number six in the eighth longest game in the history of the Stanley Cup Final, and it will start moving up the ladder very quickly if somebody doesn't score early. 1:06 to go in the power play for the Boston Bruins to start the sixth period, sudden death overtime, period number three.
If we can ever get it started.
Bergeron got the draw. Lucic and Jágr, Tory Krug, Tyler Sagan out there to start this power play. Rink wide pass, Lucic couldn't knock it out of the air, but he hustles in after the puck. He's got Sagan there with him. Bergeron's in front of the net. Jágr to Bergeron, quick shot over top of the net. And a puck came off the boards, quickly out to center. Tory Krug is back to get it. Just about gave it away to Frolik. Recovers, just about gave it away to Taves. Still trying to recover. And the puck is out to center. Half a minute to go in this power play. Milan Lucic to center. Jaromír Jágr takes over. A quick shot towards the net by Sagan. Nobody could tip it. Chara holds the puck in, a bouncing puck behind the net. Sagan to Chara, that hopped over his stick. And Jonathan Taves takes over. Back to 5-on-5. As the penalty to Chicago has expired. Two power plays for Boston in overtime, none for the Blackhawks. Here's Dennis Seidenberg. Shoots the puck in. Bruins in trying to retrieve it. Marshawn can come up with it. Duncan Keith in front of his own net. Marcus Kruger. Andrew Shaw moves in and shoots, and that's blocked by Ferentz and quickly back the other way. Krejci dumps the puck in. Brad Marchand on the forecheck. Duncan Keith up the boards. Beverly's there to cut it off. Holds the puck in. Krejci can't shoot, but he controls the puck. Boychuk with a shot. Might have deflected as Crawford made the save. Along the boards, Paille up against Duncan Keith. Chalmerson to Shaw. Couldn't control the puck. Sent back in by Ferentz. Chris Kelly quickly in. Chalmerson is checked by him. Dogovin's off the boards. His shot is stopped by Crawford. And back the other way to center. Comes Andrew Shaw. Eludes Boychuk and gets the puck deep, but he needs to get off the ice. Boychuk's back for the puck. Up the boards, Dogovin's. Into the middle. Hanzus gave the puck away. Paille straight up the middle, and Hanzus recovered and poked the puck away from Kelly. Here's Patrick Sharp. Chased by Dogovin's. Threw the puck into the corner. In to get it. Roosevelt threw the puck at the net. It was blocked. And Roosevelt's blocked as he tried to get to the puck. Boychuk. Hard up the boards. Held in by Hanzus. Thrown back to the blue line. Roosevelt keeps the puck in for Chicago. Kane along the boards is checked, and the Bruins will break up. Dogovin's has had a long shift. Kelly gets to center, dumps the puck into the Bruins. Need a change. And it must have clipped somebody at the bench, and the play has stopped.
Well, Johnny Boychuk has been one of those unsung heroes. 5 goals in the playoffs. Super slow-mo. A knuckle puck going through. A little bit of a deflection that Crawford was able to handle. This is what the crowd was reacting to. Watch the grab with the left hand of Kelly and no call.
They've had over 100 shots, over 100 hits, over 100 face-offs, and in triple overtime, that's the pass you make? That's confidence.
Chalmerson feeds the puck up the middle. It was deflected. Krejci line. Out against the Taves line again. Lucic. David Krejci. Sagan heading for the net. Krejci does a little loop. Plays the puck back. There's Krug with his shot. There's Seidenberg make that kick to side by Corey Crawford. Johnny Oduya patiently back behind his own net. Or is he just out of energy? Flipped to the blue line. Seidenberg holds the puck in. Takes the shot. Knocked down in front of the net. Lucic to Seidenberg for another try. Over to Chara. Plays the puck into the corner. Krejci. Chara moves in. The pass comes across to Lucic. Protects the puck. Krejci takes the shot. Crawford makes the save and stops play. A burst of energy from the Krejci line with Seidenberg and Chara, but they can't end it.
And that's exactly what happens. Just you sense an opportunity to end the game. You get a little bit more energy. Watch the play in the middle by Krejci. Able to just stop it with the tip of his stick and quickly get that shot away. Crawford equal to the task.
Looks like he's going to fall asleep.
Well, that really, as the guys were saying, you get kind of euphoric there. Your body's going through so much.
Bergeron won the faceoff and in behind the net gets the puck, but he can't center it. Jágr was there, overskated it. Out comes Andrew Shaw, beats Duncan Keith. How can he find the energy after about 43 minutes of playing time to get up on the rush? Shaw had the stick knocked out of his hands and appealed to the referee. Brad Marchand off the glass, but the puck stayed in. Ferentz up ahead. Marchand can't get away from Seabrook. Battles the puck back in over the line. Ferentz cleared it out of the reach of Jágr. Keith is back. Boston's changing. Seabrook tipped over the blue line. That'll happen this late tonight. And late in the game. And the Bruins, Rich Peverly. Center Dan Paille goes wide on Roosevelt. Crawford's out to play the puck. Paille blocked it. Into the corner against Leddy. Put it up the boards. Not hard enough to get it to the blue line. And the Blackhawks are quickly in bowling with a shot. And that's stopped by Tuukka Rask. That's 58 shots on Rask. Chris Kelly back the other way to shoot it. Beverly's in after it. Up the boards. Felique was back to try and get the puck and couldn't. Three nifty little passes and the Blackhawks break out to center. Michael Frolik in on Torrey Krug. Krug stays with it, plays the puck on the other side. Seidenberg back to Sagan. Delays, then puts the puck up the middle. Here's David Krejci. Stops, shoots, caught with the save. Nice club save that he knocked down. Hanzus back the other way. Patrick Sharp with some speed around the McQuaid. Backhander into the corner. Kane overskated the puck. Sagan. Adam McQuaid out of his own zone. Safely into the neutral zone and into the Chicago end. Nick Jalmerson. Tough change here again in period number six for both teams, and they're tired, which makes it doubly tough of a long change. Lucic out to center Bergeron. Jaromir Jagr. Rink-wide pass went off Seabrook's stick and into the crowd, out of play.
Well, that's back-to-back shifts where David Krejci, the most dangerous Boston Bruin, a little outside inside on Oduya, but once again, Crawford not able to grab it, but able to stab it and get it off to the corner.
Well, the one thing about Crawford is he can be caught going down early. They're looking for the Boston Bruins to try to take advantage of that. He's the top part of the net.
Bergeron won another draw. Boychuk with a shot to the net. Easy one for Crawford to stop. Back out to center. Up the middle. Hosted a saw, trying to get to the net. Can't do it. Boychuk off the board. Bergeron lifted the stick of Keith and the puck came to center. Jonathan Toews. Johnny Boychuk. Saad bounced off him. Chara to center. Seabrook backing up. On the other side to Duncan Keith. And Seabrook again. On a Boston change. Up the middle, nowhere to go. Just dumps the puck in. Boychuk, hard pass. Got it through to Peverly. As Dogovich breaking for the net, the pass is deflected. Duncan Keith takes off the other way. Boland just tipped the puck and got it in deep. Seidenberg is back. Boland on the forecheck, Shaw is there, so is Bickle, he's in the slot. Shaw turns and fell down. Kelly took the puck and he played it in front of the net. Rich Peverly onto the wing. Dogovitz has to gather it in, passed it back, it was blocked. Dogovitz again, and Letty blocked that. Dogovitz one more time, slipped the check, beats the slot. Peverly can't shoot, Kelly's there with him. And the puck will come around to Dennis Seidenberg on his offside into the middle. Corey Krug got his shot towards the net. It didn't get through. And Hanzus gets the puck back up. Corey Krug again. Seidenberg in deep. Nick Letty up the boards and back out to center. Here's Brandon Boland with a long shot. Big rebound. Seidenberg just about fell down. Got the puck to the blue line. Held in by Oduya. Walked in front of the net. Seidenberg tripped and fell. Hanzus centering pass didn't get to Boling. Make that Kruger to Boling and just didn't work out. Just about icing. Nick Jalmerson is back. Puck's tipped in by Frolik. He wants a change. Quickly back out. Milan Lucic. Jaromir Jagr. Jagr battles, he spins around. Lucic there to help him, trying to feed the point. Brandon Saad won't let him. Toews back for the puck. Gets it out over the blue line. And back in offside.
Well, some great defensive efforts. One by the veteran Char coming back. Saad has an opportunity to get in, takes him away. And then Torrey Krug getting a shift here. And defensively does a nice job, kind of in no man's land, but he's able to get a piece of that one and foil an opportunity by Boland.
Bergeron won a neutral zone faceoff. Chara shoots the puck in, bounced up in the air and bounced out of play.
Well, I look at the two benches, guys, and it's obviously late into the night, played a lot of hockey. It's the Boston Bruin bench that seems to be changing with a lot more urgency. Almost like they sense that they're close to doing something pretty special. Let's go up 1-0 in the series. Chicago bench a little bit more lackadaisical.
Brandon Saad, Toews, and Hossa on again, but Jagr comes in with the puck. Knocked away from him. Duncan Keith up the middle. Toews tried to relay to Saad, didn't get through. And Jagr comes back the other way. Over to Marchand, a bouncing puck. Can't keep it in. Seabrook knocked it out. Hossa wanted it. Now he's got it. Moves in. Passes off for Toews. He has to turn to get the puck. Toews to the front of the net. Through the blue of the crease. Keith keeps the puck in. And another puck out of play off the stick of Jaromir Jagr.
On Jonathan Toews getting that little burst of energy. And it's Hossa again. He's had bad luck around the Boston net. next one goes right through the crease, and Hossa not able to get his stick down. Does a nice job keeping the puck alive, gets it over to his captain, but then right through the crease, two guys on him, wasn't able to get a piece of it.
Peverly got the draw for Boston. And Paille tipped the puck, got it out over the blue line, and it's back in. Hanzus to Kane offside. Becomes a very plodding game at this point.
You look at the body language Glenn was talking about. Just guys with hands on their sticks, leaning on their knees.
Equipment must feel like it's 700 pounds.
Yeah.
Games played in waves. You know, we see waves of momentum where it opens up and it's lively and it's end-to-end, and then it's okay, settle down now. Let's take a couple shifts to get our rest again.
Hanzus, Kane, and Sharp in deep for Chicago. Back to the blue line, Roosevelt quickly over to Nick Leddy. Towards the net, kicked aside by Rask. Peverly's back for the puck. Got Kelly ahead of him, and he gives him the puck. Paille's on the other side. Peverly up through the middle, can't get the puck. Kelly follows him against Leddy. Tips the puck by and goes after him. Hanzus back first. Paille was on the puck and then didn't have the energy to fight off Hanzus, who could barely make it back to the bench. Patrick Kane slowly in. Roosevelt jumps up and he tipped the puck wide. Sharp. Back for Kane. Seidenberg comes at him, pushes him and knocks him down. Advances the puck. Peverly put the puck to Dogovins. He tipped it in. Oduya is back. Krejci into the middle of the ice. Here's Dogovins on his backhand. He can't bury it. And a wonderful pass from Sagan. Here's Tori Krug. Delays on the other side. Seidenberg shot. That was blocked and knocked into the corner. Dogovins getting a shift with Krejci and Sagan. Back out to center. Dogovins has got a change. Chalmers dumps the puck, and it's amazing watching players go to the bench. They can barely move their legs to get there. It's all coasting on the changes. Here's a three-on-two. Krejci, Sagan drives the middle. Krejci holds up. Cross-ice pass for Lucic. And Duncan Keith tipped it out of play.
Those moments of emotion. Dogovins can't believe it. He had a chance to be a hero, chance to end the game. Credit Johnny Oduya with getting his stick right in the hands and feet as Dogovins was trying to control this. A tough pass to handle. Dogovins keeps the puck alive. Krejci with a nice pass. And look at the last second. The stick on stick by Oduya when he's on the ground kept that one out of the net.
Oh, so close. And Krejci has been close as well. He's had a couple chances where the game has been on his stick. And we know what he's done this postseason. It's just simply the best. The reactions from the general managers, they have no impact in this game whatsoever. They've done their work to put the team on the ice, what they must be thinking.
We have a break while the ice is cleared. Dry scrape with the shovels halfway through. Period number six in what might just become the longest game in Stanley Cup final history.
Let's take a look at Krejci's body of work in the triple overtime. He's been so close to ending this game. He's got such great poise, great skill. He's got the ability to pretty much do anything. Pass, skate, he's tough as nails. And on two occasions here, so close to saying it's over in overtime.
I can tell you at this time too, you win this game and it's almost like winning an extra one. Because what it does do, I remember waking up the next day after that Edmonton-Boston game, and the first thoughts was you could barely move your hands, everything's cramped. But my feeling was, imagine how the Boston Bruins felt. And I think that for this next game, to go through this physical pain and not get a win is so damaging.
Here we go again.
Especially if you're Chicago, 60 shots on Tuukka Rask, and you come out of it losing home ice. So much for the President's Trophy.
The pass up the middle, Bergeron tried to dump the puck in. Remember, Boston's without Nathan Horton. Haven't played Sean Thornton in a long, long while. Here's Marian Hossa. In on Chara, takes the shot, caught by Rask, play is stopped.
You have to wonder, is Sean Thornton going to be the Peter Klima for the Boston Bruins? Klima didn't play from the third period on till one shift before when he scored in the third overtime. John Muckler put him out there for a short shift. His second shift in that third overtime ended up with the winner. Thornton's had two really good chances in the first overtime, hasn't he?
And he's sitting right in front of Claude Julien as if to
he's
say...
He's not going away, huh?
No, because normally he'll sit in the corner towards the end of the bench when he knows he's being planted. Not now.
Pick me. Hodges won the draw. The shot was blocked. Sharp took it. Duncan Keith. Back up the middle. Hanzus to Patrick Sharp. Got away from him. He battles with Adam McQuaid. Ferentz on the other side. Marchand to center. Krejci got the puck keep. It's Sagan, Marchand, and Krejci now. Puck is held in, thrown to the net. Poffert steered it wide. Krejci. Sagan turned and fired. An easy save for Poffert. The rebound. Seabrook was the first on it. Up the boards to Sharp. Seabrook will join the rush. Headed for the front of the net. Sharp shoots. Rask to save. Rebound. Fell in front of him. Sharp has got it. Keith wanted it. And the pass to Duncan Keith was deflected by Brad Marchand. Back to the puck to Eve Bolin. Off the boards. A bouncing puck just inside the blue line. Andrew Shaw. Duncan Keith again. Into the attacking zone. Chased by Chris Kelly. Around to Shaw. He's pushed to the ice by Seidenberg, who in turn is knocked down by Bickle to the blue line. Rosenthal to the net, score! Dave Bolin, I believe, got the last deflection on a shot by Rosenthal, and the Chicago Blackhawks have won Game 1 in a marathon.
This might have even been a double deflection. It looked like Bolin got a piece of it. It looks like Shaw coming in front as well. What a marathon shift for Duncan Keith as well. He kept that puck alive two or three times, and then, as expected, to a crowd.
...52 minutes and 8 seconds of extra time. A shot into a crowd, and the Blackhawks win the game.
Hey, look at the effort getting back to keep this play alive. As Bolin goes back hard, turn it up ice. Duncan Keith uses his speed. And this is all about just trying to create something out of nothing. Play alive with Shaw in the corner. He gets knocked down. Puck back. Watch the mobility of Rosenthal. And then at the net, looked like a double deflection. Shaw's reaction was like he got it for sure.
Well, it's the energy that Peverly had to use to get up the ice. Simmer, you talked about Chicago getting back. Yeah, they had to get back quick just because Peverly was right on their tail. And then on the way back up the ice to play in the defensive zone, nothing left in the tank for Peverly in triple overtime.
And you saw there the double deflection. Bolin knocked it back into Shaw. Tip off the stick, off the body of Shaw, and I don't think either one will care who gets the credit. Just the emotion of winning this marathon game.
So it should be Shaw from Bolin and Rosenthal at 12:08 of triple overtime, game one of the Stanley Cup Final. And the series is really on now. It started in a big way tonight.
Took 63 shots to find the back of the net to win game one.
The Bowman's excited. Cam Neely and Peter Chiarelli not so much. A double deflection with Torrey Krug, the defenseman, back, and Andrew Shaw celebrates with Dave Bolin, Brian Bickle, and the Chicago Blackhawks win 4-3. What a night! long one and a good one, especially for the Blackhawks, Ron.
Right. Cam just wants to go out there and ragdoll somebody, Jim. What a game it was. Good start to a series. We can tell there's little to choose between the two. There will be some interesting fallout to this one. Crown Royal three stars, Andrew Shaw, Corey Crawford, and Milan Lucic. And we'll come right back with Donald S. Cherry